almost a guarantee that the penalties and turnovers are going down this week.
Well, I sure hope so. Yeah, I believe they will. So we'll listen to Coach's Corner now, and then we'll be back with our pregame show from Panther Stadium. Live from Panther Stadium, Ken Ripley and Darren Hodges on KFST, AM and FM. And also, we're going to be on Facebook Live tonight, KFSTradio.com, and we'll be on our Google channel. Just search for KFST on Google, and you'll find us. All right, we'll have Coach's Corner coming up next.
Bill Moody. Bill Moody.
Did you say he thought it was like all
did you say YouTube?
Google him.
Did you say YouTube also?
Yes.
There is
did I say you?
Yes. There's Ash. That's Ash Norman right there.
Okay.
He's the freshman quarterback.
Stay tuned now for Coach's Corner.
So on YouTube, Tristan, how do you find it?
KFST AM FM radio.
On YouTube. Okay.
Search for. Just search for KFST and it'll come up.
Yeah, when I search KFST, it came up.
Yeah, okay. I'm not going to do it at the restaurant. I'm going to be here. Soon. If people want to watch, they can come in.
Kyle.
Great. This is great.
Are they?
Are you already on Facebook?
I just told Kyle.
Some things on display last week.
Crane's woman, too.
I was excited to see the ball push side to side, also push down the field for our guys to make plays. I was excited to see the defense really get after the quarterback. The things that were put in place by our defensive coordinator, you know, Benny Ellison, put their offensive line in a bind, and our defensive line and linebackers had a good first half getting after the quarterback, and it made it very uncomfortable for those guys. But overall, the Panthers played really, really hard, and it was fun to watch those guys kind of tap out. If you watched it, we had a lot of guys trying to get out of the game for them, and that's what we're trying to get out there and be physical with them. But I was excited to see some things, and there were some things that we have to work on as well, and I'm not pointing out the things that people don't understand. The turnovers and penalties, once again, were something that we have to focus on and try to get better at. But overall, the Panthers went out and represented our community and did a great job at that.
And it was against a 5A Division I opponent, so pretty impressive. All right, Coach, the Panthers scored 4 touchdowns in the first half and another in the second half. How did you think the flow of the game was for us?
Well, you know, the first half, again, we moved the ball around and really did some things real well. And then we had some turnovers that kind of got in the way. The second half, it wasn't really a lack of focus. It may have been a little bit. We didn't score as much as we wanted to, but we also got some other guys in the game and did some things that we wanted to work on from that point forward. I was really proud of Pedro Gonzalez, his game. He made some great plays and really showcased some skills that he had. And, you know, and so – you know, overall, I thought the flow of the game went well. I thought, again, the defense really played well and really kind of answered the call quite a bit over those turnovers on those momentum swings, getting the momentum back on our side.
Well, Coach, the Panther defense shined, as you mentioned. You know, they had recorded, if you count those first 2 quarters of this ball game against Horizon, that was 8 shutout quarters of football that they had played, and they only allowed that field goal in the 3rd quarter. So, that is quite an accomplishment. So how's the Panther defense doing?
Well, they've really worked hard. And, again, my background is in defense. And for you know, probably 90-some percent of my career focused on that. And this group of kids has worked as hard as any that I've ever been around. But the ability to make plays and the ability to play as a team is unlike anything I've been around. And we've had some really good defenses in the past in my career. But these kids really play well together, and they work off each other. So it's very fun to watch them work together, and I'm inspired to see them practice and work. And I think you're going to see another good show this week because they had one of the best weeks of practice that we've had since I've been here. So I couldn't be more excited about the defense and the way those guys are coming together. It's really been unlike anything I've seen in my career.
All right, let's talk about the Panther offensive performance against Horizon. How do you think they did?
Again, the first half moved the ball around well. We threw it well. We ran it well. We did have a few little mishaps here and there, but we were able to kind of showcase some of the things we've been working on with our run-pass offense and the RPO style that we're trying to implement and push the ball down the field. But also, you know, throw them out of the box is what I mean. Is they're putting 7 to 8 men in the box right now, and we're trying to throw the ball outside to get those things corrected, to get them, to get the looks that we want in the box. We know that we can run the football. There's not a doubt about it. But we've also got to be able to throw it as well. So that's what we were focused on last week. And we did do a good job the first half with that. But I was happy with some things. Our offensive line, again, had a few guys play really well. And our running backs well stood out. And Marco did some good things here and there and showed some improvement. And so, you know, we're working hard each week to get that moving and just to get us to be – to reach our potential by the last week of the season. It's a process, and we understand that.
All right, Coach, usually a team with 8 turnovers loses the ball game. So 8 turnovers and quite a few penalties. How can we get better in these areas?
First off, again, the defense stepping up on those turnovers. You don't win games turning the ball over 8 times. That's unheard of. But our defense, again, is getting to the point to where they feel like they can stop anything. But with that being said, in practice this week, I've said this again, and I said this before, and I'll say it again. We have to focus on that, and we changed some things in practice. Again, to reiterate that, if there was a penalty in practice, the kids were out. If there was a turnover in practice, they were out. And then we did some extra running this week to kind of understand that we've got to protect the football. The football is what wins games, and we've got to protect it. And so there's some things that were implemented this week, and then there are going to be some things in the game implemented that they're going to understand. We're going to protect the ball, or you're not going to play.
Well, and it's kind of like a virus that gets out of hand, you know, and the other team sees that, and they start trying to rip the ball out, and that's what Horizon certainly was doing.
Absolutely, and you hit the nail on the head right there, and it happens to teams. Sometimes they just kind of – it takes over, and this is something that's happened, but it's something that can easily be stopped. The kids are more than capable of that, and we just have to focus on it and not make a huge deal out of it, but understand that it's important. Protect the football. And that's what wins the game. And so we've done some things differently, and I fully expect it to look better this week.
All right, Coach, and pretty good balance this past week with the run versus the pass.
So yesterday that we want to be balanced, and we want to be able to take advantage of what defenses are giving us. If they're piling in the box, we're going to spread it around and throw them out of it. If they're spread out, then we're going to run it and take advantage of that. And we're just in the process of really putting together a – 50-50 split or 60-40, which is really good, and that's a game time deal. If you know 60% pass, 40% run, if that's what they're giving us, or vice versa, 60% run and 40% pass. But we're putting things in play to take advantage of what defenses are giving us.
Yeah, and it seemed like you found some success with the short passing game, particularly out in the flats. Obviously, that was part of the strategy.
That's correct. Again, they're piling the people in the box, putting 7 or 8 men in the box, and so we've got to throw ourselves out of it. And defensive linemen get tired of running side to side. If we can move fast, get lined up with good tempo, and throw the ball side to side, those guys get tired. And then when they're tired, then we can line up and run right at them, and we'll start gashing them in the second half with big chunk plays on the run game.
Okay, let's assess the special teams and kicking game in this past ball game.
Isaiah Garcia had another great punt return. I mean, that guy just wills himself into great plays, and he's an explosive player. Kickoff coverage was really good. We did have some punt coverage things that we worked on this week, and also some PAT things that we've worked on this week. And as you guys have seen, we run our gate stuff, so we'll go for 2 here and there to put pressure on the defense and understand that our foot's on the gas. If they're not lined up and ready, we're going to go after it and try to see if we can't steal a point or two.
Well, Coach, this was a 5A Division I opponent. How would you assess the Horizon Scorpions?
Well, like I said last week, they had some athletes, and they did have some athletes. But what the Panthers did is went out and took it to them early and kind of broke their will to compete. And so that surprised me on how fast they wilted. They started to realize, you know, within that third quarter, you could see the look in their eyes that they didn't want anymore. And that's a testament to the effort and the intensity that our kids played with.
You know, and I believe that Escobar, running back number 20, looked like a little bowling ball. He was a tough running back, but the Panthers did a great job on him.
He ran really hard, and I think early in the game they threw a little swing pass to him, and Randy Sandoval came up and hit him pretty well in the legs, and that kind of slowed him down for the rest of the game. But not many times did he not get popped by 3 or 4 guys, and in reality, I think our defense really broke their will to compete the way they swarmed, and when they arrived at the football, you know, it was physical.
Okay, Coach, you mentioned Pedro Gonzalez. Any other standouts you'd like to mention in last week's game?
Again, Isaiah Garcia had another explosive night. You know, the entire defensive line really got after it. You know, Xavier Dominguez had a great night. Both defensive ends, Dominic Bernal and Zane Hodges had a great night. Yeah. Darren Uresti, I mean, it was just a phenomenal night for those guys. But also, you know, hats off to Marco for having a good first half and moving the ball around. Again, we are doing some upper-level things on offense, and it takes time. So, you know, he's improving each week, and our offense is improving. So I was proud of that first half of them.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll be back with more Coach's Corner right after this.
Spring Branch Water Well Service offers complete sales and service of windmills, pumps, pressure tanks, water storage tanks, polypipe, and offers generator rentals as well as testing and plugging. They're equipped with a well camera and will work at residential, commercial, agricultural, industrial, and oil field locations. They're located at 2905 West 9th Street. For great customer service, call day or night at 336-7867. That's 336-PUMP.
Cassandra's Flowers and More is located at 803 West Dickinson next to Citibank, and they offer beautiful floral arrangements for every special occasion in your life. They also feature personalized baskets made to order, green and blooming plants, balloons, and of course roses, and feature the best prices in town. Call Cassandra's Flowers and More to place your order, 336-8809. Cassandra's Flowers and More, 803 West Dickinson.
There's a great new coffee, tea, and sandwich shop now open in Fort Stockton. It's Brew Lane Cafe Express at 302 East Dickinson. They have fresh and delicious
volleyball weekly.
Brew Lane Cafe Express also features all kinds of coffees, including espresso, cold and nitro brew tea, lemonade, mocktails, and energy drinks. Call for orders to go at 432-360-04. Open Monday through Friday, 9 to 4, lunch hours 11 to 3, or until sold out. Brew Lane Cafe Express, 302 East Dickinson. CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton has a complete line of CBD oils in many varieties, along with ointments, lotions, and beauty products. Many also come in capsules and gummies. They also feature treats and oils for your pets, sanitizers, sprays, and gels. CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton, bringing wellness to the world. Every day can be a great day with CBD. Go by CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton at 808 West Dickinson Boulevard, Suite A.
All right, we continue with segment two of Coach's Corner here with Panther head coach Jeremy Hickman. Coach, now we've got this week's opponent, the Crane Golden Cranes, and only about 52 or 3 miles away from us. What do you know about this team?
Well, I'll tell you, Crane has gotten better on film each week, and I fully expect them to be much better than they were last week. Brand new coach, he got there in the middle of the summer and started implementing some things, but you can really see them improving each week. They've gotten really good on special teams. Their defense is very sound. They don't miss many tackles. They don't miss a line very much. And the offense, a lot of formations that can get us in a bind if we don't stick to our rules and understand that. So they're gonna present some things to us that we're gonna have to answer the call.
All right, this is a team, the Golden Cranes. They're 1-2 this year. They did beat Kermit. They lost to McCamey narrowly and to Reagan County. So how have they looked so far in the first three games?
Again, like I said, they've gotten better each week. I'm not looking at the record and the scores of the game. I'm just looking at the way the kids are kind of improving each week. I fully expect them to come in here and give it their best game. And now, is their best game good enough to beat us? I can't tell you that. I'm more concerned with us playing our best game and getting better. So outside of that, you know, I feel good about our game.
All right, what would you say are the biggest strengths of this Crane team?
Their quarterback's really good. The quarterback has a good arm. He keeps things going. Plays alive. Their running backs run hard, and that's going to be an issue. They block pretty well. But defensively, I think, is probably one of their strengths. Again, like I said, they're very sound. Don't miss a line much. Don't miss many tackles. But they do put some things out there that if we execute, we'll be able to get some explosive plays on them. But I think their defense and quarterback are probably their top things.
Okay, and what kind of offense and defense are we going to see from Crane?
Offensively, you're going to see a pro-style offense and some wishbone and eye formation things that move things around, put multiple linemen on each side, some unbalanced things, some X over or receiver over formations that are run oriented. They're going to try to run the ball and shorten the game up. Defensively, They're an odd front. They're going to line up in an odd front. They're going to give us a seven-man look up in the box, and then they're going to play some zone, and they're going to play some man. So we've seen this stuff in the last couple of games. We saw four-man front last week or even front, but this week, you know, it's similar to what we've seen the first two games.
Okay, and what would you say the talent level, strength, size, and depth of this Crane team, how does that match up with the Panthers?
Well, the Panthers match up well against them. I mean, like you said, we've played better people than they've played, and it's going to show. But we've got to come out and do our thing and play our game in order to be successful. The Crane can sneak up and beat you. There's no doubt about it. That's Crane, and played those guys many, many times, and it's been ball games in years past, you know, decades ago. Yeah. But, you know, the ability is there, and they've gotten better every week, and that's what's scary. They've gotten better every week, so how much better did they get this week? And that's the question.
Okay, we'll take another break here on Coach's Corner. We'll be right back.
There's a great new coffee, tea, and sandwich shop now open in Fort Stockton. It's Brew Lane Cafe Express at 302 East Dickinson. They have fresh and delicious hot homemade sandwiches with a rotating menu bi-weekly. Brew Lane Cafe Express also features all kinds of coffees, including espresso, cold and nitro brew tea, lemonade, mocktails, and energy drinks. Call for orders to go at 432-360-0421. Open Monday through Friday, 9 to 4, lunch hours 11 to 3, or until sold out. Brew Lane Cafe Express, 302 East Dickinson. Cassandra's Flowers and More is located at 803 West Dickinson, next to Citibank, and they offer beautiful floral arrangements for every special occasion in your life. They also feature personalized baskets made to order, green and blooming plants, balloons, and of course roses, and feature the best prices in town. Call Cassandra's Flowers and More to place your order, 336-8809. Cassandra's Flowers and More, 803 West Dickinson. CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton has a complete line of CBD oils in many varieties, along with ointments, lotions, and beauty products. Many also come in capsules and gummies. They also feature treats and oils for your pets, sanitizer, sprays, and gels. CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton, bringing wellness to the world. Every day can be a great day with CBD. Go by CBD American Shaman of Fort Stockton at 808 West Dickinson Boulevard, Suite A.
Spring Branch Waterwell Service offers complete sales and service of windmills, pumps, pressure tanks, water storage tanks, polypipe, and offers generator rentals as well as testing and plugging. They're equipped with a well camera and will work at residential, commercial, agricultural, industrial, and oil field locations. They're located at 2905 West 9th Street. For great customer service, call day or night at 336-7867. That's 336-PUMP.
All right, we're back with Panther head coach Jeremy Hickman here on Coach's Corner for our final segment. Coach, what are the keys to getting the win in this ballgame tonight against the Crane Golden Cranes at our homecoming?
I want to see us play hard. I want to see us play clean, and we've got to be able to eliminate the turnovers, and that's the key. We've got to play our game. We've got to execute the offense, execute the plays called, and we've got to swarm on defense.
You know, eventually you would think that the turnovers are going to eventually cost you.
They will eventually cost us. There's no doubt about it. You can't win big games doing that.
Yeah. Okay, Coach. The offensive Crane, any particular things that you're going to have to do to contain them?
Well, it's just lining up to their formations. When we line up against their offense again, they're very multiple formation-wise, and they move people around to try to get the numbers on their side, and we've got to be able to see that, adjust, and keep our rules intact.
Okay, you think the offensive game plan will be similar to last week that we'll see against Crane tonight?
I think you're going to see some more stuff coming out. We put some things in again to try to progress, and so you're going to see some similar things that you saw last week, but you're also going to see a progression of the offense this week.
Okay, let's talk about our injuries. Man, I tell you, Horizon had several players go down last week. How about our injury and wellness situation?
You know, the Panthers are somewhat healthy for the most part. We have some bumps and bruises, some guys that are nursing, you know, some injuries, but nothing that's going to keep anybody out of the game.
Okay, that's good news. So the attitude of the team, let's talk about that now. 3-0 on the season. It seemed like the defense at this point is almost invincible, but let's knock on wood when we say that, right? But 3-0 on the season, the Panthers have got to be feeling pretty good right now.
Right, and again, we're process-oriented, so we're just trying to get better each week. And I will tell you again, like I said, this week of practice was the best one we've had all week. The kids practiced hard, practiced physical, and they moved around really, really well. So I'm excited to see the product that we put out there. And again, the community excitement, the kids' excitement, I mean, it's there. We just got to keep working.
Okay, and, I know we're looking to improve on last week's performance. Is it mainly the turnovers, which is the stigma right now that we got to get over?
It's the turnovers is probably the big one that we want to improve on, but also just the execution and being detail-oriented and making sure that, you know, when we run these plays and we're blocking our heads on the right side, that our hand placement is right. I mean, it's just getting better at some of the details of what we're focusing on. So that's what I want to see this week, just the detail-oriented play and also, you know, eliminating the turnovers.
Yeah. Okay, and it's homecoming here in Fort Stockton. So does that create distractions for your team?
I would like to say no, but, you know, I understand how big homecoming is in Fort Stockton, and I think it's great. And I think the kids, we've done this enough here that they understand that we do have a parade. We do have a bonfire, which is fantastic. That is such a special thing in Fort Stockton. But I also think that they understand that there's a game here, and they understand that the football game is the reason that people are coming to see them play. Yeah. So the distractions are there, but I think our kids have focused, and again, we've had a great week of practice.
Okay, I know you want to invite all the Panther fans out to Panther Stadium. Last home game, we had a huge crowd. Tonight, it's homecoming. Should be even bigger, so that'll be great.
That's correct. And like I said, we've had a lot of, like you said, there's been a lot of ticket sales. There's no reserve tickets. Those have all been sold out for a month. And so general tickets, you're going to have to get here early and get your tickets. I think we're moving in some stands because we've had so much people call, so we're going to have some temporary seating for that as well. But get here and cheer those Panthers on. They're working hard for the community. And the community support has been overwhelming, and I know our kids have talked about it several times on how much excitement they see, you know, in our community. So thank y'all for that.
Well, Coach Hickman, congratulations on being 3-0, and good luck tonight against Crane.
Yes, sir. Thank y'all so much. Fort Stockton, we're playing for you. Thank you.
All right, and that's going to wrap it up for Coach's Corner this week. I'm Ken Ripley for KFST.
You have been listening to Coach's Corner with KFST's Ken Ripley and head coach and athletic director of the Fort Stockton Panthers, Jeremy Hickman. Coach's Corner is brought to you this season by Spring Branch Waterwell Service, Cassandra's Flowers and More, the Brew Lane Cafe Express, and by CBD American Shaman. It's time for the pregame show with game announcers Ken Ripley and Darren Hodges. This year's pregame show is brought to you by Bella Terraza, Miller Meat Company, Edward Jones Investments, Terraza's Furniture, and by Fort Stockton Body Shop. You'll hear starters for the game and analysis of this week's matchup. Let's join Ken and Darren for the pregame show.
And good evening, everyone. This is Ken Ripley along with Darren Hodges. We're back here at Panther Stadium live tonight for our homecoming game, the Fort Stockton Panthers. We're expecting a big crowd tonight here in Fort Stockton. And we've already had the homecoming festivities, I believe, haven't we, Darren?
Yes, they named the homecoming king Cruz Rojas, and the queen was Jacinda Gonzalez. So,
all right, so
we've got those already named.
Congratulations.
And a huge crowd.
We've got a big crowd, yes, and still gathering. So the weather conditions here tonight, we've got beautiful clear skies, temperature of about 89 degrees, and we do have a stiff wind out of the south-southeast. 10 to 20 miles per hour tonight, Darren.
Yeah, it is. That wind's fluctuating. I've seen it reported a number of different directions tonight. So, yes. But you know what? It's going to be a great night. Our stands are in the shade, and it's going to be very pleasant.
Well, let's take a look at Crane's schedule so far. They're a 1-2 on the season. They started with a loss to the McCamey Badgers, and McCamey's got a good football team. And that was a loss by only 7 points by Crane, 28-21. McCamey won that one. And then their second game, they defeated Kermit by a score of 32-23. And then last week, they played the Reagan County Owls, and that was in Big Lake. And so they lost that one 16-6 last week. So what do you think of their schedule so far?
Well, we've played a harder schedule, but, you know, I was listening to Coach's Corner, said they're getting better every week. They've got a new coach, a new system. So I expect them to come out. Used to be our first game every season and a really tough rival. So yeah. I expect them ready to play. It's a close game, just 50 miles. But I do think we're going to win.
All right. And Fort Stockton, of course, Darren, we're 3-0 on the season. Looking to go 4-0 tonight, hopefully. We started out by playing El Paso Austin here at home. That was, I believe, was that 4A Division I opponent, I believe.
I think that's right.
And we won that game 18-16, kicked a field goal late in the fourth quarter to win that one. And then we played Alpine on the road and won that one 27-0. And then we played last week Clint Horizon and won that one 31-3. And Clint Horizon, a 5A Division I opponent. So the Panther defense has played very well, Darren. We've only allowed a total of 19 points on the season in three games. So that's 6 1/3 points average per game that our defense has allowed. And that's excellent scoring defense so far.
Well, the defense has played very well, especially when you consider the number of times they had to trot back on the field after a turnover. So
yeah.
The defense is good. And the offense, I thought, in the first half of the games has been very good and then disappears in the second half.
Well, and Darren, we varied up the offense quite a bit last week, sort of gearing the offense to some of the skills we have. And so it was better, I thought, last week, and a more varied offense, and our passing game looked better last week.
Well, I think it is. I think we're playing for the future. We've had some trouble throwing the ball, but we're going to work on it because at some point in the season we're going to need to be able to pass the ball. And so I like that we are working on things, our weaknesses, to make them stronger.
Yeah, and playing to some things that we can do as a team. And that's good coaching. So Jeremy Hickman, of course, in his first year as head coach of the Fort Stockton Panthers, and he's a Fort Stockton native. And so we're wishing him and all the Panther coaches and Panthers all the success this season. We've got a new district. We're in 4A Division II this year as opposed to 4A Division I, which we were elected to be in the last 2 years. And now this year we're down back in Division II, and we've got three teams out west and three teams here in our area, Monahans, Pecos, and Fort Stockton. And then we've got Fabens, Mountain View, and Clint out west. So that'll be our district this year. And I believe we're the only undefeated team left in our district.
Well, it is. And one of the nice things, I think our tougher games are going to be at home this year. I believe we play maybe Pecos, Monahans, and Clint all in Fort Stockton.
Yeah, so that's going to be a good schedule for us. We've got the starters for Fort Stockton. We did not get the Crane starters this week from the Crane head coach. They've got a new head coach as well. Michael Pittman is their new head coach for the Golden Cranes.
All right. You want some offensive starters?
Well, we're going to take a break first, and then we'll be back with your offensive starters, Darren. We'll be back right after this. One of Fort Stockton's greatest treasures is Bella Terraza, downtown Fort Stockton, the fabulous gift and home decor store. Amy makes frequent trips to the market and brings back many special and unique items that would be a great addition to any home. For glassware, pottery, Western items, unique home furnishings, antique items, kitchen items, pictures, mirrors, and much more. Shop Bella Terraza today with great prices to suit West Texas. Visit Bella Terraza, downtown Fort Stockton at 116 North Main. The old days of a local butcher shop are still here with Miller Meat Company of Fort Stockton, where you'll find that old-fashioned quality and service. You can even call in your order and they'll have it ready for pickup. Something new is the Tomahawk Steak, a large whole rib, a bone-in ribeye steak, 2 to 3 inches thick and delicious. They have pre-seasoned meats available too that are great for barbecuing, like shrimp and beef kebabs, fajita pinwheels, and sirloin steaks. Miller Meat Company at 1013 North Nelson. Call today, 336-2979.
Financial investments are very important, but so are the investments of time, patience, and encouragement our young athletes receive from their coaches, teachers, and mentors. Sal Salazar, your Edward Jones financial advisor, understands this. That's why Edward Jones is a proud sponsor of the Fort Stockton Panthers and Prowlers. For all your investment needs, call Sal Salazar at 432-336-3611, your financial advisor. Edward Jones, member SIPC.
When you need expert auto body repair, see the guys who've been in the business for many years at Fort Stockton Body Shop, 102 West Hornbeck. They offer auto body repair from minor fender benders to repairing your vehicle after a more serious accident. They'll repair and paint like new along with replacement parts needed, and your vehicle will be working like new again. They also offer auto glass repair and replacement and window tinting. Free estimates also available at Fort Stockton Body Shop, 102 West Hornbeck.
Be sure to shop the great deals at Terrazas Furniture downtown Fort Stockton. They have the largest selection of furniture in the Trans-Pecos and have the most affordable prices anywhere. They're your authorized Ashley Furniture dealer with so many different styles of bedroom suits, dining room suits, living room furniture, recliners, entertainment centers, and more. All major credit cards accepted, plus they have in-house financing available. See Terrazas Furniture today for all your home furnishings at 106 North Main, downtown Fort Stockton.
All right, we are back now on the pregame show, and Darren Hodges, you've got the starters offensively for the Fort Stockton Panthers tonight.
I've been anxious for a while to do these starters.
Yeah.
Tonight, starting on Fort Stockton for offense, at flanker, number 7, Pedro Gonzalez, a senior, had a great game last week. At running back, number 8, Jadrian Ramirez, he's a senior. Quarterback, number 10, Marco Garcia, he's a junior. Wide receiver, number 11, Isaiah Garcia, he's a senior. Wide receiver number 14, Kai Norman, he's a senior. Wide receiver number 15, Zane Hodges, he's a senior. At left tackle, number 50, Julian Leyva, he's a junior. Left guard number 58, Andre Washington, he's a sophomore. Right tackle, number 62, Andres Sotelo, he's a sophomore. Right guard number 65, Aiden Villarreal, he's a sophomore. And at center, number 75, Cruz Rojas, he's a senior.
All right, so those are the offensive starters for Fort Stockton. Not sure about the starters for Crane, but we'll pick those up as we continue our ball game tonight. Crane is making their way out onto the field. They're going to be dressed in their white jerseys with purple numerals and purple helmets, trimmed in gold, I believe. And Fort Stockton making its way onto the field. I think we've got some new home uniforms on tonight.
Well, we got to, they're blue and white,
yeah.
Lots of blue, and I like that.
Okay, we'll be back with the second part of our pregame show right after this.
When you need expert auto body repair, see the guys who've been in the business for many years at Fort Stockton Body Shop, 102 West Hornbeck. They offer auto body repair from minor fender benders to repairing your vehicle after a more serious accident. They'll repair and paint like new along with replacement parts needed, and your vehicle will be working like new again. They also offer auto glass repair and replacement and window tinting. Free estimates also available at Fort Stockton Body Shop, 102 West Hornbeck.
Be sure to shop the great deals at Terrazas Furniture downtown Fort Stockton. They have the largest selection of furniture in the Trans-Pecos and have the most affordable prices anywhere. They're your authorized Ashley Furniture dealer with so many different styles of bedroom suits, dining room suits, living room furniture, recliners, entertainment centers, and more. All major credit cards accepted, plus they have in-house financing available. See Terrazas Furniture today for all your home furnishings at 106 North Main, downtown Fort Stockton.
If your saving for retirement approach involves the phrase, "I'll get around to it someday," Edward Jones can help. When it comes to meeting your goals, time can be on your side. And there's no better time than now to get started towards your retirement goals. Edward Jones financial advisor Sal Salazar can help. For all your investment needs, call 336-3611. Edward Jones, making sense of investing. Member SIPC.
The old days of a local butcher shop are still here with Miller Meat Company of Fort Stockton, where you'll find that old-fashioned quality and service. You can even call in your order and they'll have it ready for pickup. Something new is the Tomahawk Steak, a large whole rib of bone-in ribeye steak, 2 to 3 inches thick and delicious. They have pre-seasoned meats available too that are great for barbecuing, like shrimp and beef kebabs, fajita pinwheels, and sirloin steaks. Miller Meat Company at 1013 North Nelson. Call today, 336-2979. One of Fort Stockton's greatest treasures is Bella Terraza, downtown Fort Stockton, the fabulous gift and home decor store. Amy makes frequent trips to the market and brings back many special and unique items that would be a great addition to any home. For glassware, pottery, Western items, unique home furnishings, antique items, kitchen items, pictures, mirrors, and much more, shop Bella Terraza today with great prices to suit West Texas. Visit Bella Terraza, downtown Fort Stockton at 116 North Main.
Okay, we're back, and we've got the defensive starters now for the Fort Stockton Panthers. And tell you what, we may take a break here for the national anthem. So they may, I believe we're going to go ahead. We'll air that here tonight, try to get that on the air as we stand for the national anthem. The national anthem, and Darren, now the defensive starters.
All right, starting on defense tonight for the Fort Stockton Panthers. Number one, Darren Reste, he's a senior. At defensive end, number four, Dominic Bernal, he's a senior. At outside linebacker, number six, Jordan Franco, he's a senior. At safety, number eight, Jadrian Ramirez, he's a senior. Free safety, number 11, Isaiah Garcia, he's a senior. Outside linebacker, number 12, Felipe Sotelo, he's a senior. At safety, number 13, Isaiah Velasquez, he's a junior. At defensive end, number 15, Zane Hodges, he's a senior. Cornerback, number 20, Ethan Acosta, he's a senior. At cornerback, number 30, Randy Sandoval, he's a junior. And at nose guard, number 54, Xavier Dominguez, he's a senior.
All right, we'll be back with our kickoff coming up here on KFST AM and FM, KFSTradio.com. And we're on Facebook Live and on YouTube tonight. We'll be back in a moment.
You have been listening to The Pregame Show with Ken Ripley and Darren Hodges. The Pregame Show has been brought to you by Bahia Terraza, Miller Meat Company, Edward Jones Investments, Terraza's Furniture, and Fort Stockton Body Shop. Sit back and enjoy Panther football. It's time for the kickoff.
It's time now for Fort Stockton High School Panther football on KFST AM and FM and KFSTradio.com. Panther football is brought to you by Buck's Lube Center, Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, the Pecos County State Bank, Cassia Ledesma State Farm, D&L Well Service, Amistad Motors, the Steakhouse Restaurant, Farmers Insurance Agent Adelina Salazar, the First National Bank, Hernandez Sanitation, B3 Properties, by Rainwater Motor Company, Sawyer Insurance Agency, Citibank, K-Bob Steakhouse, Heritage Funeral Home, M&J Fast Lube, Julie's Easy Press, M&J Trucking, the Oasis Truck Tire Center, the Sagebrush Cafe, and Lowe's Marketplace. Panther football also brought to you by Weiss Tire, Designer Carpets and Interiors, Pepito's Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, Cactus Health Services, Triple R Welding, the Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Porky's Ice House, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, The Water Factory, Salceda Family Medicine, Alamo Tire and Auto Repair, Concept Inc., CTG Express, Fort Stockton Insurance Agency, Fort Stockton ISD, Ram Country of Fort Stockton, Triple G Supply and Services, by Big Ben Concrete, West Texas Eye Care, and by Panther Pictures. Now tune in for Fort Stockton High School Panther football.
Okay, we're back here at Panther Stadium. We're ready for the kickoff of tonight's game. Looks like we're going to be kicking off a couple of minutes early. Number 24 for Crane will be Kevin Iniguez, and he is a junior. He's going to be kicking off, I believe, for the Golden Cranes, and from his own 40-yard line. Crane, I believe, won the toss, and they deferred, so we'll take the ball first. It's taken at the 24-yard line by Fort Stockton. And on the return there is number 13 for the Panthers, Isaiah Velasquez, and he will return it for about 15 yards up to the 35-yard line, a 15-yard return for Velasquez, and the Panthers will have it first and 10 against the Golden Cranes on our first possession of the ball game, getting the game underway here at Panther Stadium in Fort Stockton tonight.
Well, you know, nice job of coming up and fielding a line drive kick. And he was about one tackle away, got a one-arm tackle to make it, could have had a bigger gain.
All right, Marco Garcia in the shotgun, and he's got Jadrian Ramirez, his running back, three receivers on the right, one on the left. And here's the pass out in the left flat, and Crane is all over that, and they're going to cause a big loss on the play. The Pedro Gonzalez, the receiver there, you know, he was contacted initially right when he caught the ball. He was well covered. Then Pedro tried to reverse field and go the other way, and it caused an even bigger loss. So that is going to be a 13-yard loss, second and 23. Marco in the shotgun, two receivers on each side for the Panthers. And here's the handoff, and this will go to Jadrian Ramirez up the middle. There's a flag coming in from the middle of the field. And that would have been about a 5-yard gain up to the 27-yard line, but it's a holding against the Fort Stockton Panthers. So, Darren, on the second play of the game, Fort Stockton has a holding penalty, and we'll see if Crane takes it or if they're going to, you know, take the down.
I don't know.
When it's declined.
Yeah, it's already going to be third and very long. So
okay.
Yeah, they saw Pedro last week have three scores in that short passing game. They came up quickly and tackled him on first down.
Okay, so now it's third down and 18 for the Panthers after the big loss on first down. They declined the penalty. Here's Marco rolling out to his left. He's being rushed, and he's being under a lot of pressure. He cannot get rid of the football, and he's going to be sacked. Number three for the Golden Cranes, Blake Rodriguez was the guy who got to him. And he was helped out by another defender, but that's Blake Rodriguez causing the big loss, and that brings up a huge fourth down for the Panthers. And, man, we lost a total of 18 yards on, you know, 18 yards net lost on that series of downs.
Yeah, that wasn't any good at all. And yep. We did hear earlier that the strength of Crane was their defense. They play good defense, and I tell you, we couldn't get away from them.
Okay, here we go with Cruz Rojas. And a punt, and we've not had to punt that many times in our three games so far this season. But this is fourth and 18, and here's Cruz, puts his foot into it, and Crane takes it at the 45-yard line, Fort Stockton territory, and there's one tackle missed, and there's a block in the back on Crane. Crane returns it down to the 15-yard line, number four on the return for Crane, Trey Larson. But there was a big, obvious block in the back at the Panther 42-yard line, so that should be coming back from there.
Well, I think they're going to call a blindside hit. I think he might have got around, but, you know, you've got to be – when you're blocking downfield on a punt, you've got to hit a guy, come right in front of him. If you come anywhere from even the side and hit him in the front, it's a penalty, and I believe this is going to be a 15-yarder.
Yep, that's a 15-yard penalty, and you're right. It's a blindside block. And so that will back Crane up into their own territory. So that's a pretty good break for the Panthers because Crane had returned the ball down to about the 15-yard line.
Well, it is, and there was some talking. I think Crane is fired up, and they were – I saw Cruz talk. And we want to give a shout-out to Cruz's dad, Richard Rojas. We hope he's back with us soon. He's not been feeling that well. So get well, Richard, and come back.
Okay, first down and 10. Yeah, get well, Richard. And now, is there a flag on the play? Crane is going to re-huddle. It's first down and 10 at their own 42-yard line. Yeah, there's a flag thrown.
I think that, well, let's see if they said something else. But anyway.
We've got 10:02 remaining in the first quarter. And the M&J Fast Lube game score update, 0-0 as Fort Stockton failed to convert to a first down on the first series of downs. In fact, lost 18 yards net on that first series. And now we're going to see Crane's offense for the first time tonight.
Yeah, they're chatting quite a bit over there, but I do know that Pedro got hit with a blindside hit, and it really knocked him off his shoes, and you can't do that anymore on punt plays.
Well, there was no penalty marked off, but they sure took a long time allowing Crane to get started on this offensive drive. Okay, it's first and 10, Crane at their own 42-yard line. Crane with an offset I formation. And there's the pitch back to the I back, and they will have about 3 yards up to the 45-yard line. We'll see who the ball carrier is here. And I believe it's number 5 for Crane, Brian Galindo. Yeah, I believe that's the ball carrier. And it is 2nd down and 7, ball at the 45-yard line for Crane.
Well, I think we heard that Crane would probably take their time and run a lot of plays, try to eat up the clock tonight.
Okay, here's Crane under center. The quarterback is Keaton Senna. And there's a handoff, and that's a 1st down. Oh, that might be a horse collar tackle on Fort Stockton, I think. So that would be a gain for Crane of about 9 yards on the play, on the running play. And I think, and that's a 1st down, by the way, for Crane. And I believe you're going to add to that a horse collar tackle by the Panthers. And so they're going to get 15 more yards.
Yeah, he did. You could see him reach out and got him by the shoulder pads and yanked him straight down. And wow, that's already 2 penalties, big penalties on Fort Stockton to start this game. Yep. Only 1 accepted.
Okay, so here we go. It's 1st and 10 for Crane at the Panther 31-yard line. They started at their own 42 and now down to the Panther 31 with some help from some penalties. Crane now in the shotgun. And they will fake the handoff. The quarterback is hit by number 11, Isaiah Garcia. Great play. That's going to cause a loss of a yard on the play by the keeper, by the quarterback, Keaton Senna. It'll be bring up a 2nd and 11. Garcia with a great hit.
Well, it was. Came up quickly. Nice job that time, Panther defense. They got some penetration. And then Isaiah comes up from his safety position and cleans it up.
So it's 2nd down and 11, ball back to the 32-yard line of Fort Stockton. Crane in the shotgun with Keaton Senna, the quarterback. He will fake the handoff, now throw the ball deep downfield, and it's incomplete, way overthrown.
Yeah, that wasn't even close.
Not even close.
Receiver was about the 12-yard line, and that landed halfway into the end zone, so that ball was overthrown by almost 20 yards.
And that's intended for Trey Larson for Crane. Now 3rd down and 11 for the Golden Cranes at the Panther 32-yard line. There's no score in the ball game. Game score update brought to you by M&J Fast Loop. 3rd and 11, I formation for the Golden Cranes. Quarterback under center. Hands off to the fullback. Nothing doing for Blake Rodriguez, who lost another yard on the play. That's a loss of 1, bringing up 4th and 12. Fullback got the handoff, Darren, and that time it was smothered by that Panther defense. I didn't see who got the tackle, though.
I believe it looked like Zane Hodges and Darren Uresti came in on that left side and really got him in the backfield.
So 4th down and 12, ball back to the 33-yard line now. Now we've got a receiver on each side for the Golden Cranes in a wing left formation. Well, it's a quarterback in the shotgun, actually, offset eye. Here's a quarterback, and he's going to throw downfield in a wide open receiver. There was nobody covering Manuel Aranda on the left side. He was just wide open, nobody within 15 yards of him. But the quarterback overthrows him, and it's incomplete, and a break for the Panthers. And the ball turns over on downs to Fort Stockton at the 33-yard line.
Yeah, the coaches are talking. One of our defensive backs, you know, he got caught looking in the backfield, and the guy, he stopped, and then he took off, and our guy was still looking. And tell you, we were lucky they didn't score a touchdown on that play.
Now he was just wide open on that play. 1st down and 10, Panthers, after the Golden Cranes turn it over on downs. And the shotgun formation, here's another flag coming in from the far side. This may be a motion penalty. That was Corbin Luna, who got about a 3-yard carry right up the middle.
It's motion, but, or they're offsides. I think Crane was lined up in offsides
okay.
that time.
You're right. So it's an offsides penalty against Crane. We'll take the penalty. And the ball is moved up to the 38-yard line, where it will be 1st and 5 for the Panthers. Now, we've got a different quarterback in the ball game. It is Zane Natividad at quarterback. Here's the fake handoff, and now Natividad will go around the right side, and he's up to about the 40-yard line. Gain of 2 for Natividad, and it's 2nd and 3. So already a quarterback change here, but I'm not sure if we're going to, you know, alternate them or just perhaps alternate the series. No, Natividad is staying in there.
Staying in there. Good to have Corbin Luna back. He's missed a couple of games.
Got a slot man on the left side, wide receiver on each side. Here's the handoff to Corbin Luna. And Luna will have a first down. That's a Rainwater Motor Company first down on a gain of four by Corbin Luna up to the 44-yard line. Again, a Rainwater Motor Company first down. And, Darren, one of the most positive things about that play is no flags.
It is, and really a nice hard run. He was hit after about a yard but was able to keep pushing the pile forward.
Now TV Dodd at quarterback, two receivers on the left, one on the right. And the handoff again to Luna, and he is wrapped up immediately by Ivan Martinez for Crane.
Got a
and
flag.
There's a flag on the play. Did that come in after the play?
It did. I think he might have grabbed him by the face mask also. So we'll see what the call is going to be.
Okay, so let's wait on the head official to make the call. One official I can see is making the face mask motion, so let's see.
It looked like after he grabbed him, as he's spinning him around, he grabbed his face mask and pulled him on down.
That's right, personal foul face mask on Crane. So that will give the Panthers a Rainwater Motor Company first down, down into Crane territory.
Yeah, his initial hit was fine. He wrapped him up, but then as he was trying to spin him around, he reached up and grabbed him by the face mask and pulled him on down.
So it's a Rainwater Motor Company first down at the 41-yard line for the Panthers in Crane territory. Fake handoff, and now here's Zane Natividad with a nice run, close to 10 yards. That's down to the 32-yard line, maybe the 31. We'll see. Yeah, that's an 11-yard pickup and a Rainwater Motor Company first down. Did we call it exactly 10 or 11? Okay, 10 yards picked up by the quarterback, Zane Natividad. First and 10 at the 31 of Crane.
That's a great fake.
It was. Two receivers on the right, one on the left. And the handoff goes to Corbin Luna. And Luna evades a tackle and breaks a couple and gets down to the 28-yard line. Pick up about three for Corbin Luna. And it's going to be second and 7. You know, Luna has not seen as much playing time, I'm sure, as he would like this year. I think he's been hobbled by an injury early in the season.
Well, he has. He wasn't feeling well, but he is back tonight.
So it's now 2nd and 7. The ball down to about the 28-yard line of Crane. Here's another handoff to Luna, and he goes around the left side across the 25, right at the 25, as a matter of fact, where it'll be 3rd down and 4 coming up.
Well, we need a good drive. I think Crane really came out hitting. You know, they came out ready to play. They know they're the underdog tonight, and they came out and hit us early. But nice drive by Fort Stockton on this second drive.
Okay, it's 3rd down and 4. Zane Natividad at quarterback on this drive. Two receivers on each side. Fake handoff. And now it's a pass caught in the right flat and really good coverage by the Crane defense. The pass completed, let's see, to number 7, Pedro Gonzalez. But Crane covers it very well, and there's no gain on the play. A completed pass for no gain, and we're at, in fact, we may have lost a yard. It's 4th down and 4 coming up.
Well, this will be a big play. I don't think we will punt here, and I don't think we can kick a field goal.
We're in the first quarter, 4:09 to go. The game's scoreless. Game score update brought to you by M&J Fast Lube. Need a first down. It's 4th and 4, and we're going for it. I formation. Now, TV Dodd up under center will pitch it back to Luna, or is it Jadrian Ramirez, perhaps?
Jadrian Ramirez for the first down.
He's got the first down. That's a Rainwater Motor Company first down. We'll pick up 6 yards on that play, down to the 19-yard line of Crane. That's a Rainwater Motor Company first down for Jadrian Ramirez. Nice pitch play by Zane Natividad to Jadrian.
Now, that's our heavy package. Isaiah Velasquez is the quarterback. He's under center. He pitches it back, and then he's the lead blocker, and it's worked well for us in short yardage.
All right, good deal. Here's Zane back at quarterback. Jadrian behind him. Two receivers on the right, one on the left. Here's the handoff. It goes to Jadrian Ramirez. And Ramirez will have good yardage. That's about 7, down to the 12-yard line. And, of course, Fort Stockton in the red zone. I think they're going to mark it for 6 yards.
Really a nice run. Jadrian Ramirez running hard right up the middle. And tell you, Fort Stockton just working right now, trying to establish the run. I have a feeling we're going to hit them with a big pass in a minute downfield. We've thrown only short passes so far.
All right, Zane Natividad at quarterback. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. There's a fumble, and Zane Natividad has barely got back on the football. He almost lost control of it. And, while he was on the ground, we did get the ball back, and there's a flag downfield.
Yeah, Kai Norman at the end, he was doing a nice job blocking. But at the end of the play, after a good block, he went ahead and pushed the crane player one more time, and the official saw it, and we're going to have that call back for a personal foul.
Okay, so I guess, is that a dead ball foul?
I think it's a dead ball foul. So, I think it was after the play.
So they would mark it back from where Jadrin recovered that fumble.
Yes, they would.
And that would be big-time trouble for the Panthers here on penalties again. Now we're going to have a third down and long?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's 15 yards after the loss, so I tell you, that really hurt.
All right, third down, 28 yards to go. Ball is back to the 37-yard line. That just could kill this drive, and that would be a shame. Ball back to the 37. Zane Natividad at quarterback. Two receivers on the right, three at make it, and one on the left. Here's the handoff, and that goes to number 13, Isaiah Velasquez. And Isaiah will have yardage up to the 35, and that's all. It's about a 2 or 3 yard gain. And it will be fourth and very long for the Panthers. Fourth and, gosh, we've got to get inside the 10 for a first down.
Now we're going to have to punt, and there's another, silly penalties. I tell you, it was a bad enough play, but then add 15 yards. We can't have those penalties, and they keep coming. I think that's the third or fourth penalty called against Fort Stockton in the first quarter.
All right, let's see if Cruz Rojas can pin Crane deep in their own territory. He's back there to punt. The line of scrimmage, the 35-yard line. He fumbles the snap, and it was almost blocked. But there's Cruz, and it takes a Crane bounce all the way back to the 30-yard line. That winds up being a 5 or 6 yard punt.
Well, that's bad, and we didn't even see it till it was too late. It bounced back 10 yards.
We'll be back in just a moment.
Buck's Lube Center is located at 310 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. They feature quick oil changes, multi-point vehicle checks, inspection stickers, and fuel filters for all vehicles, specializing in mobile oil, but with Motorcraft also in stock. Buck's Lube Center is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 5 p.m. Remember, for reasonable prices and great service, it's Buck's Lube Center, 310 West Dickinson, Fort Stockton. They hope to serve you on every oil change.
All right, we're back with more Panther football. There's a handoff by Crane on their first play. After that punt by the Panthers, they gain a couple. It'll be second down and 8 for the Golden Cranes.
Well, the good news, we've gone almost the entire first quarter without a turnover, but the penalties are still hurting us.
Really are. The penalties have been a problem for the Panthers this season. Second and 2. There's a pitch out to Crane on an option play, and the Panther defense handles that extremely well. I don't believe they gained anything on that play. Maybe a yard. It's going to bring up 3rd and 7 for the Golden Cranes. Ball at the 33-yard line. 3rd and 7.
Well, our defensive backs, focus on your man. Don't play any other positions, because last time Crane had a man that on a stop and go just burned us, but luckily it was overthrown.
Okay, we've got 3rd and 7. A receiver on each side in an I formation, Crane under center. They'll hand it off up the middle. Great defensive play again by the Fort Stockton Panther defense.
Really was, I tell you, just stuffed him.
And, you know, there's a lot of bodies on the inside. It's hard to see who got the tackle, but I think that it was number 14, Kai Norman, I believe.
And, no, he's not on there.
No? Okay, there's a timeout on the field. We'll be back with more Panther football in a moment.
Do you know where to get a great lunch special for a very affordable price? At Bienvenidos Mexican Restaurant, of course. Their lunch special is only $8 and is served Monday through Friday at lunchtime. Monday, it's a fajita chicken salad. Tuesday, the taco plate. Wednesday, the vaquero sandwich. Thursday, Bienvenidos Nachos. And Friday, the enchilada plate is on special. And don't forget to come by Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. for a delicious Mexican-style breakfast. That's Bienvenidos, open Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. at 405 East Dickinson.
This is Dakota Livesay for the Pecos County State Bank. In West Texas, our word is our bond, and commitments are solid. The Pecos County State Bank takes our responsibilities with your money and your life very seriously. At the Pecos County State Bank, you will find employees who pledge to protect your privacy, secure your investments, and honor your individuality. You will find commitment. A West Texas institution since 1928, Pecos County State Bank, all the bank you'll ever need. Member FDIC.
Okay, we're back at Panther Stadium. It's punt time for the Golden Cranes on 4th and 7. They punt. That's a very nice punt over the head of Isaiah Velasquez. He takes it at the 5-yard line and will return it up the right side and be knocked out of bounds at around the 21. And Isaiah trying to brush off the tackler there, but that's where we'll take over. And Crane really gained a lot of field position on that exchange, Darren.
Yeah, that was Isaiah Garcia, number 11, returning that punt. But they did. That was a booming punt that almost, I don't know, had a chance to go all the way into the end zone.
Isaiah Garcia returns it to the 21-yard line. We do have a stiff wind out of the south, and, of course, Crane had that wind behind him with that punt.
Well, it's a smart timeout. Call timeout, punt with the wind, and pin us deep.
First and 10, ball is at the 21-yard line, I believe, and we've got Marco Garcia back in at quarterback. And here's Corbin Luna. He will go forward for right at 10 yards. I believe they're going to mark him a little short of the down marker. We'll call it 9 to the 30-yard line. It'll be 2nd and 1 for Corbin Luna. And it's the end of the quarter. We are scoreless. That's the score update brought to you by M&J Fast Lube. We'll be back in a moment.
Stuck in a state of falling behind? Struggling to keep up with your kids, finances, insurance? Then let State Farm Automobile Insurance Company help you simplify and get to a better state. Because I, Kessia Ledesma, your local State Farm agent, can handle your auto, home, and life insurance, so you'll have more time for everything else. Call me today at 432-336-8575 and get to a better state with State Farm.
D&L Well Service is expanding, and they specialize in roustabout work for any of your oil and gas needs. D&L is just a call away with over 50 years' experience in roustabout work, environmental cleanup, remediation, maintenance, installation, fabrication with access to welders and miscellaneous equipment. And if you want it pretty, we paint too. Call Harold Dunn today at D&L Well Service at 432-336-8101 or 290-0852.
All right, we're back at Panther Stadium. The Panthers will now have a 2nd and 1 as we start the second quarter. We are scoreless in Fort Stockton. Crane showing some pretty tough defense on the Panthers here in the first part of this game, and so are the Panthers. Here's Corbin Luna with a nice first down run. That'll be a Rainwater Motor Company first down, gain of 5 to the 35-yard line. And, again, it brings up that first down for the Panthers.
Well, now that we have the wind, I expect we're going to take a shot deep, see if we can get a big play.
All right, it is 1st down and 10, ball at the 35. And we've got a fumble on the play. Crane has got it. Number 12, Keaton Senna, who plays quarterback, just recovered a Fort Stockton fumble. And that is Crane getting the first turnover of the ball game. That's our first turnover. We had 8 of them last week. We had 4 in each of the first 2 games. And now we've got one here against Crane, and that sets them up in great field position.
Yeah, it looked like the quarterback took his eye off the snap. Is a little low, but I think he was looking for his running back and then just couldn't find the handle.
So Crane will have it now 1st and 10 at the Panther 32-yard line. Senna is in the shotgun with 2 backs beside him and 2 receivers, 1 out on each side. And here's the handoff, and that is number 5 for Crane. He makes a great cutback run all the way down to the 10-yard line of the Golden Cranes. That's a 22-yard pickup and a 1st and goal for the Golden Cranes at the 10.
Wow, that was a great run, I tell you. And Isaiah Garcia comes in and tries to tomahawk the ball at the last minute, makes a nice touchdown-saving tackle, but boy, he gashed the left side of our defense.
Who was the ball carrier, Darrell? Did you get that? Okay, that was Brian Galindo, the ball carrier. Great cutback run. It's 1st and goal for Crane at the Panther 10. And here's the handoff for Crane, and that's going to be a loss on the play. Great defensive play by Isaiah Garcia. He causes a loss of three on that play, so great pursuit, and, you know, brings him down from behind for a three-yard loss. It's second and goal from the 13.
Really a nice job, and Crane's got to go make it all the way to the end zone. So, again, good stop. Let's see if we can hold them out. Maybe they'll try a field goal, but maybe not.
Second and goal from the 13. Crane sends a receiver on each side. Same formation. Quarterback in the shotgun with two running backs on either side. Quarterback back to throw, and it's a slant pattern into the middle, and it looked like it was actually batted down by number 13, Isaiah Velasquez, for the Panthers. And so that's an incomplete pass on the slant into the middle of the field. It's going to be third and goal from the 13.
Really a nice job. There's decent coverage, but Isaiah was right in the path of the ball, and he was able to reach out and just tip it away. And big third down for the Fort Stockton defense.
Yep, third and goal for the Golden Cranes. Same formation, two receivers on each side, quarterback in the shotgun, and two running backs on each side, one on each side. Here's the quarterback in the shotgun to throw, and into the end zone. It is caught. I believe it's a touchdown. Yes, it is. Number four was the guy who caught the ball, Trey Larson, and that is a beautiful fade pattern into the end zone, and he just laid it perfectly right over the defenders. Larson is a very big and tall receiver, and he made a great play.
Well, we got to get ready. They're working on the swinging gate. Let's see what they do.
Yeah. It's 6-0 Crane. That's our M&J Fast Lube scoring update here. Now they're going to try the extra point. The holder will be Senna, and the kicker, I believe, is number 10, Angel Reyes.
I think replay is going to show that he was juggling that ball and did not catch it.
And that's a blocked extra point by the Panthers, and we will try to pick it up. Ball is still on the ground, and Fort Stockton picks it up and is returning it. Jadrian Ramirez is brought down at the 35-yard line, almost got free and returned that for two. Well, it's 6-0 Crane with 10-12 left in the second quarter. And that's our M&J Fast Lube score update. We'll be back in just a moment.
Get enrolled today for the My Rewards program at Amistad Motors. Earn points that can be used not only in service, but also to purchase accessories. For every new vehicle, you can earn up to 10,000 points, which can go towards oil changes or any other service you might need. Amistad Motors, 2110 West Dickinson. Call 336-9000.
The Steakhouse Restaurant has been serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area for many years with consistently great food and fast, friendly service. They offer daily lunch specials on weekdays at a great value. Each special comes with appropriate sides, super salad, and drink. And they were voted to have the best steaks and enchiladas in Fort Stockton. The Steakhouse Restaurant, open Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. till 9 p.m. at 1100 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton.
Well, we're back at Panther Stadium, and we're not happy about the score right now. It is 6-0 Crane on top. That's the M&J Fast Lube scoring update. And it's been a mistake-filled first half so far for the Panthers. Let's see if we can get things on track.
Well, it really is. And, again, turnovers. Eventually, they cost you.
And penalties. Penalties killed our last drive. All right, it's taken, the kickoff, taken at the 25-yard line by Pedro Gonzalez. And Pedro is up to about the 37. So about a 12-yard return for Pedro up to the 37, where Fort Stockton will set it up first and 10. But Crane leads the Panthers 6-0.
Well, I think Crane is more fired up than Fort Stockton. It's our homecoming.
Yeah.
And you know what? We're just not we need to step it up. They're playing with a lot more emotion right now than Fort Stockton.
Yeah, they're certainly more fired up, it appears, than we are. But we got to get some emotion going and stop making mistakes. We've had the penalties have killed us. And then that one turnover cost us a touchdown. First down and 10, Panthers. And there is Marco Garcia, fakes the handoff. I tell you, the defensive guy for Crane was right in their face when they were about to hand the ball off. So That was not very good blocking by the offensive line. They got through there immediately and caused disruption on the play. And so Marco throws it away on the right side. There was nobody out there, but that was just a desperation play, throwing it away. Sets up second and 10.
Well, at some point, we're going to have to take a shot down the field because they're coming off our receivers. I watched them. They had two guys covering three because they're ignoring our passing game.
All right, we've got two receivers on the right, one on the left. And here's Garcia, throws it to complete to Pedro Gonzalez on the right side, and that's going to be a pickup of 10 yards on the pass play. That's a Rainwater Motor Company first down, and a pickup of 10 or 11 for Pedro.
Well, now they're moving it back. And
are
so
they?
We may have that same official that he marked it, then he moved it back half a yard, but they're still signaling first down.
Yeah, 10 yards. First down and 10, Panthers at the 43-yard line. I believe it's, Marco in the shotgun. Handoff to Corbin Luna. Up the middle, big run. Down to the 20, brought down at about the 18-yard line. That's 34 yards on a first down run. That's an outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking Company on just a handoff right up the gut, and he takes it for 34 yards. Panthers with the hurry-up offense. We snap the ball, and it's a timeout by Crane because they had a defender running off at the last moment. Crane, timeout. We'll be back in just a moment.
Sawyer Insurance Agency has six locations in West Texas to serve you, including 706 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton and 1502 South Stockton Avenue in Monahans, along with offices in Pecos, Midland, Lubbock, and Amarillo. They offer the most complete line of commercial and personal insurance from workers' comp, general liability, business and personal auto, commercial property, equipment, oil and gas, farm and ranch, and home insurance. Contact Clyde, Nathan, or Travis Sawyer today by calling 336-7543 or 943-9600.
Once upon a time, a person's banker knew them by name. They saw their banker as a partner, a resource, and even a friend. Bankers used to do more than hold your money and process your checks. Bankers used to help you build your dreams. At First National Bank of Fort Stockton, we offer you that kind of banking again. For buying, building, or remodeling a home, for commercial banking, for personal banking from your first checking account to the last bank you will ever need. The First National Bank of Fort Stockton, member FDIC, equal housing lender. NMLS number 410651.
All right, we're back here, and we've got the Panthers with a first and 10 at the Crane, I believe it's the, 17-yard line. Here's another handoff to Corbin Luna. Luna brought down inside the 10-yard line. It will still be second down, I believe, but that's a nice gain on first down of about 7, maybe 8 yards.
Now we're missing a couple of linemen. Alec Galindo and Andre Washington are out for this game, so maybe some adjustments needed up front.
Marco Garcia in the shotgun, flanker on the left. Here's the handoff to Corbin Luna again. He's inside the 5 down to the 4-yard line. And that'll be a nice pickup, about 6 yards, and that's a Rainwater Motor Company first and goal. Outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking Company. Corbin Luna has been on a mission this drive, it looks like.
Well, I think, emotion will carry you so long, but I think Fort Stockton's starting to get their blocks and picking up big yardage up the middle.
First and goal at the 4, Marco in the shotgun. And the handoff again to Luna. He's in there standing up. He wasn't touched until he was in the end zone. That's a triple R welding score by Fort Stockton. And a 4-yard touchdown run by Corbin Luna. Beautiful play. I mean, there was just nobody that touched him until he got into the end zone, Darren.
We found something working right now, and I tell you, that the running and blocking right up the middle, we're just knocking them off the ball.
Let's see if we can take the lead with the extra point. Aiden Villarreal to kick the extra point for the Panthers. Holder is Marco Garcia, and the kick is up. It's low. And it's good. Panthers take the lead, 7-6. That's the M&J Fast Lube score update on that Triple R Welding scoring play with the PAT. We'll be back in just a moment.
Hernandez Sanitation in Fort Stockton proudly serves a large portion of West Texas with sanitation services, including the oil field, for portable toilets, holding tanks, septic tank service, grease trap service, or large roll-off trash containers. Contact Hernandez Sanitation today by calling owner and operator Joe Angel Hernandez at 432-336-3803. Hernandez Sanitation, a proud member of the Fort Stockton community, always supporting all the athletic and extracurricular activities in Fort Stockton schools.
B3 Properties, managers of the Apache, Green Tree, Chaparral, and Sunset Apartments, and managers of A1 Mini Storage are having a move-in special. That's right, right now, check out the move-in special going on their apartments and storage buildings. Don't miss out on these great move-in specials. Stop by B3 Properties at 808 West Dickinson or call for more information at 336-5003.
Okay, we are back with more Panther football here on KFST, AM and FM, and KFSTradio.com. We're also on Facebook Live tonight, and we're on YouTube as well. And so thanks to Tristan Barragon for running our camera tonight for Facebook Live and for YouTube. By the way, they're having a fifth quarter out there tonight at the convention center, which is where the movie theater is located. And so I'm sure Tristan would like to see everybody go out there tonight to the fifth quarter celebration. But first, we need to win this ball game. Here's an overhanded catch by Crane as a kickoff almost went over the receiver's head. But he made a great catch and a great return on that play. Manuel Aranda, you know, caught the ball and returned it for about 17 yards.
Now, he's the guy that also caught us on the blocked extra point. So, very speedy player for Crane.
Well, I thought that was a pretty nice job of him catching the ball over his head there, which is about to go by him, but he caught it and returned it for 17. Pretty smart play.
Well, our defense needs to step up. We gave up a long touchdown pass last time. We need to clamp down.
First down and 10 now for the Golden Cranes. I formation. There's a flag coming in from the near side as Fort Stockton bottles this up for perhaps a loss on the play. Oh, it's offsides on Fort Stockton.
I think our defensive back on this side was all the way across the line as he was trying to guard a receiver that was back off the line of scrimmage.
Okay, so we've got an offsides against the Panthers. And Coach Hickman not too happy about that, and he's
bringing that guy out.
Yep. First down and 5 now for Crane. We get another penalty right there, and Crane has a first and 5 at their own 42-yard line, puts them in much better shape. They've got a receiver on each side, split backfield, and the quarterback in the shotgun, Senna. And he will hand it off. He does hand it off. That was a pretty good fake. Obviously, faked me out. There's no gain on the play. He handed it off to Brian Galindo, who hurt us with a big run earlier, but that one stopped for no gain. It's going to be 2nd and 5.
I thought he lost a half a yard. He got a very, very lucky spot there.
Yeah. Our M&J Fast Loop score update with 7:26 and counting in the second quarter. Fort Stockton 7, Crane 6.
Well, Fort Stockton's going to have to step it up. Crane is playing very well, and they're showing some good passing and running.
Okay, 2nd and 5 for the Golden Cranes. Split backfield again. Here's a quarterback faking the handoff, and then a completed pass to number 7, Carlos Garcia. And that's the delayed, you know, handoff, and he put the ball, quarterback did, right in the belly of the running back. Then at the last moment pulled it out and threw it out to the left flat for a gain of 3, and it's 3rd and 2.
Well, the penalty hurt us. We'd stopped them for no gain on first down, so that free 5 yards, the extra play, really hurts.
Yep. 3rd and 2 for Crane, ball at the 45 in their own territory. Now they come up under center with an I formation. A receiver on each side, fumble on the play. And let's see, Fort Stockton says they're on it, and we are. They lost a yard on the play, fumbled the ball, and the Panthers recovered that fumble. So there's a Crane turnover, and so each team now has a turnover in this ball game.
Well, that's a great stop, I tell you. From 1st and 5 to Fort Stockton football, what a nice job by the Panthers.
And maybe Darrell can tell us total yardage at this point in this game. I'm not sure who did get the fumble. Did you see it?
I didn't see who picked it up.
I didn't see who got it. It was a mass of bodies there. But we've got first and 10 for the Panthers, ball at the 44-yard line. And it'll be Marco Garcia in the shotgun, two receivers on each side. And the lone running back, I believe, is Corbin Luna. And here's Garcia back to throw, and it is a pass that is incomplete. The ball in the air a very long time there, intended for Isaiah Garcia down the right side. The slow movement of the ball allowed both defenders to get there. And, you know, it would just have to be Isaiah going up to grab it, but he couldn't grab it that time. It was knocked away, second and 10.
Well, it did. It hung up in the air quite a while, and Fort Stockton took a shot deep. Let's see if we can hit another big play right up the middle.
All right, second down and 10 for the Panthers. And here's a handoff to Corbin Luna. This time Corbin is stopped right at the line of scrimmage. His forward progress is going to give him a yard, maybe two. But that's all. That time, Crane solved the up-the-middle play, at least that time, and it's a third and about eight coming up for Fort Stockton.
Now, I think they gambled. I think they knew we were going to come back with a running play, try to make it a more manageable third down.
Two receivers on each side, quarterback in the shotgun, and he rolls out to his left. Here's Marco going to try to turn the corner, tries to tiptoe the sidelines, and he's about 2 yards short of the first down, but a pretty nice gain down the left sideline. And it's probably four down territory here, where it's fourth down and two for the Panthers at the Crane 36-yard line. Not a bad play down the left sideline by Garcia. Pretty fast.
Pretty speedy. Got the corner, almost tiptoed to the first down.
All right, here we go on fourth and two. We're going for it. We were trying maybe to draw them off sides. And now here's Garcia on a fourth and two. And he will hand it off to Luna. That's going to be very close. I think the near side official, with his spot, we're going to have the first down. It's going to be a gain of two.
It's a first down.
Yeah, it's a first down. It's a Rainwater Motor Company first down. That's an outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking Company to convert a fourth down into a first.
Well, it really is, considering it was third and long, about third and eight, and good job for the Panthers to pick up that first down.
All right, it's first and 10, ball at the 34 of Crane. Shotgun for Garcia. Fake handoff. Now Garcia will run around the left side. He is slammed down very hard at the 31-yard line. Gain of 3 yards for Marco Garcia brings up a second and 7 for the Panthers.
Good job by Marco. He read that everyone was going after the running back, was able to pull it back and make some good yardage.
Took a pretty hard shot. Two receivers on the left, one on the right, flanker on the right. Here's a quick pass to Pedro Gonzalez. He's all the way down to the 20-yard line, and that's an 11-yard pickup for the Panthers on the pass play. That's an outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking Company, and it's a Rainwater Motor Company first down. Boy, that was a quick pass.
Really a nice job getting that out quickly. I tell you, he looked it off and then fired to Pedro. Big first down.
First and 10 at the Crane 20-yard line in the red zone. Handoff to Corbin Luna. Luna's got about six, down to the 14-yard line of Crane. Second down and four coming up after a nice gain on first down by Corbin Luna.
Really is. Fort Stockton offense has done some nice things on these last two drives. Maybe some of it is we have the wind behind us now.
Second down and four coming up for Fort Stockton. We're in the red zone. Garcia in the shotgun. Another quick pass to Pedro Gonzalez, and he breaks, evades one guy. There's a flag coming in the defensive backfield.
And that guy threw that from 30 yards away. And really, I like it. They're gambling on the running game, and their safety is having to come up and tackle Pedro from about 20 yards away.
Well, that was a 9-yard pickup for Pedro on the quick pass, but the flag comes in the defensive backfield, and let's see what is going to happen here.
I think he's wrong. I think he was calling us for blocking downfield, but that ball was back at the line of scrimmage. I think he's wrong.
It's a first down. Oh, they're waving it off.
Yeah.
They're waving it off. That's a first and goal for the Fort Stockton Panthers. Outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking, and it is a first and goal brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company.
He didn't know what he was talking about. There was blocking, but it was after the pass.
Well, you know what? It's good that they waved it off. They discussed it, and that was the right call. Shotgun for Garcia. He will hand it off again to Corbin Luna. Luna dragging players down inside the one-yard line. That's going to be a nice gain again of about 7. Just inside the one-yard line for Corbin. Not a touchdown yet, but it's so close.
Really good job hanging onto the ball. You could see the Crane defense trying to pull it loose, and he hung on and kept turning for a nice gain.
Second down and goal from the one-yard line with 3.5 minutes to go, second quarter. M&J score update is 7-6, Fort Stockton leading. Second and goal at the one. Marco Garcia in the shotgun with Luna behind him. And a timeout by Fort Stockton. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with more Panther football in a moment.
America can depend on Farmers Insurance agent Adelina Salazar to provide you with low-cost insurance coverage in all areas of your life. Farmers can provide auto, home, life, health insurance, and much more. Farmers Insurance agent Adelina Salazar also writes commercial property insurance policies for liability, fire and casualty, and more. Contact your West Texas Farmers Insurance agent, Adelina Salazar, today next to the post office at 104 East 4th. Call 336-5311.
Your dreams are what power our community. When it comes to buying a home, starting a business, or tools to help with everyday money management, Citibank is a proud community leader for your financial needs. From personal checking and lending solutions to mobile banking and a suite of business services, our goal is to help you achieve yours. Citibank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Okay, when we come back, we've got a second and goal here for the Panthers. We are ahead 7-6 in the game. The score brought to you by M&J Fast Lube, and we're hopefully threatening to have a triple R welding score right here. Let's see. We're coming in with offset eye formation and the quarterback in the shotgun. And here's the quarterback handing it off. Corbin Luna is going to be stopped for a loss on the play of a yard. So it will be third and goal now from the 2-yard line. So Crane defended that one very well.
Well, they did. They're shooting every gap. They're not even guarding our receivers. And we had everyone in, so they just said, we'll bring everyone right up the middle.
By the way, I had a score a moment ago from Imperial at their homecoming. They're leading Sierra Blanca 22-13, first quarter. And there is Corbin Luna. He's in there for the touchdown, 2 yards on third down, and that's a triple R welding touchdown run by Corbin Luna. 13-6 Panthers. Corbin's got both of our touchdowns tonight, I believe. We're leading Crane in total offense right now by about 127-42.
Nice drive.
127 yards for us. Okay, let's see if we can get another extra point. The first kick was very low, but it was good. Here's Aiden with the kick. It's a low snap. That's a much better kick, and it's good. 14-6, and that's a triple R welding score. And the M&J Fast Lube game score update, 14-6 Fort Stockton. We'll be back in a moment.
Head on down to K-Bob Steakhouse in Fort Stockton, where we're serving up mouth-watering, hand-cut steaks, juicy burgers, chicken fried steak made from scratch, homemade mashed potatoes, and much more. Whether it's lunch with friends, a family dinner, or a special occasion, K-Bob's is always here to serve you the food America loves. K-Bob Steakhouse, Fort Stockton, at 2800 West Dickinson.
Lowe's Marketplace is your hometown grocery store, serving our area for many years, offering USDA certified meats, fresh produce, groceries, frozen foods, and bakery items made fresh. They also support our schools with the Register Tapes for Education program, where you can turn in your Lowe's receipts to the schools for much needed educational equipment. Lowe's Marketplace at 1300 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton, supporting Fort Stockton schools. Come by today.
All right, we're back, and the Panthers will be kicking off to the Golden Cranes after scoring a 2-yard touchdown run by Corbin Luna. M&J Fast Lube score update, 14-6 now, Fort Stockton leading.
Well, our last two drives, no turnovers. I don't know if we had any penalties. And tell you, we put it right down the field, and now we're in the lead.
All right. Here's the kickoff by Aiden Villarreal for the Panthers. This is a squib kick. And, boy, that's going to roll down inside the 10, picked up by Crane. And a chance for
fumble.
Oh, there's a fumble. And I believe on that hit on the return man, Fort Stockton got the fumble recovery.
Oh, they
and
hit
I believe
him.
It was number 73 maybe who got the recovery for us. Everardo Sandoval, I think, got the fumble.
Well, really a nice job. The ball hit. That was a line drive kick. At one of the up men for Crane touched it, and then it kept going all the way back around the 6 or 7 yard line. Crane picks it up, and I tell you, number four running. Hey, the guy that's got their touchdown, pretty speedy,
yes.
He got hit, lost the ball, and a great job by the Panthers.
And that was a hard hit on the return man, Trey Larson. I'm not sure who caused the fumble, but that was a great defensive play by the Panthers on the return. And Fort Stockton gets the benefit of a turnover. It was clearly a fumble, and I believe Everardo Sandoval got on it. It's first and 10 for the Panthers at the Crane 25-yard line. Marco Garcia in the shotgun. Two receivers on the right, on the left, rather, and one on the right. Here's a pass in the end zone, and it's into the middle in front of Isaiah Garcia. He could not quite get to it, but, you know, it was up in the air again a very long time, a wobbly pass. But Isaiah almost got to it, but couldn't quite get there.
Yeah, I thought he was going to catch that. I thought it was put up in the middle. I thought he had a chance to make a play on the ball. But I think the wind just pushed it far enough over that we couldn't reach it.
Shotgun formation, second and 10. Here's the handoff. Corbin Luna, great block in the middle. Corbin's got a first down. 5, touchdown. That is a 25-yard touchdown by Corbin Luna, but there's a flag at the 5-yard line.
They saw Kai holding right at the end of that play, and they're going to bring it back. He had a hold of the guy, and, you know, he grabbed him by the shirt and twisted him around, and he looked guilty, and they saw it, and they're going to flag him for holding.
Yeah, but let's see, you know, is it still going to be a first down? Because they're marking the hold at the 5. It's still going to be a first down. It's a net gain of about 11 yards or maybe 10 down to the 15-yard line. It's 10 yards. But it's still a first down, even though we got called for a holding penalty.
Well, it is another good play, and I don't even think we needed it. I don't think they were going to make that tackle.
Well, that's the second big penalty on Norman tonight. First down and 10, ball at the 15. Shotgun formation. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Handoff goes to Corbin Luna. He's not going anywhere this time. They stop him right in his tracks at the line of scrimmage, and it's second and 10. He might have lost a half yard.
Well, they guessed right that time. They really brought a run blitz right up the middle, brought, you know, both the linebackers and got him.
And, Darren, did you see the blocking on that play where Corbin scored the touchdown?
Yes, it was.
It was really nice on the left side of that offensive line. Second and about 11 now. And Garcia in the shotgun. He will hand it off to Corbin Luna, and Luna will gain about 3. Perhaps.
Well, it's going to be a big third down. A minute and a half here in the half, third down. You know, we're in field goal range probably, but we need a touchdown.
Well, it's third and 9. So they've stopped Luna on the last two plays very nicely, and it's third down and 9. Crane playing some pretty good defense at times, especially in the first part of this game. Okay, third down and 9. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Garcia in the shotgun. Fakes the handoff. Slant pattern, touchdown. And that is number 11 for the Panthers, Isaiah Garcia, with a 14-yard catch. And there's a flag in the middle of the field again on the Panthers.
I tell you, that was a perfect pass on the slant. Great catch. Got into the end zone. And they're going to say, how do you have an ineligible man downfield on a play that fast? That's crazy.
Ineligible man downfield is what they call on the Panthers, a 5-yard penalty. Back to the 19-yard line now, and it's third down and 14 from the 19.
Wow.
We got to get inside the 5 for a first down.
I don't,
this is
I don't see how you can have a man downfield on a pass that's just bang bang. And I tell you that I don't believe it.
Well,
I
Coach Hickman is out on the field and very upset about it. I think
that happens on a long running pass play, not on a quick slant. I'm sorry.
Okay, third down and 14. Yeah, you very rarely see that on a play like that. Third down and 14, and there's two receivers on the left, one on the right. And we're taking a long time here, and we're going to call a timeout, I believe. And that's a timeout by the Panthers. Panthers leading 14-6. That's the M&J Fast Lube score update. We'll be back in a moment.
If you or your spouse have been thinking about pre-planning your funerals, Heritage Funeral Home of the Big Bend has some very important news. Now is the best time to plan for your eternity and take the financial burden off your loved ones. If you already have a plan, let them review it with you. At Heritage Funeral Home of the Big Bend, they'll work with you so that your final requests are personalized just for you. Call or come by today at 301 North Main or message them on Facebook.
Need a quick, efficient oil change? M&J Fast Lube at 116 West Dickinson is here to serve you. Martine and Julia Ibarra invite you to stop by. They have great service, and they offer auto oil and lube services with the top major oil brands. They also offer state inspections and vehicle washing and cleaning. Or you can get your vehicle completely detailed. It'll look like you just bought it. That's M&J Fast Lube, 116 West Dickinson, supporting Panther and Prowler Sports. Go Blue!
All right, we're back with more Panther football. We've got a very important third and 13 here after the timeout. Marco Garcia in the shotgun. He's back to throw, putting it into the end zone, lobs it in there for Isaiah, and he's got the touchdown. That time, the lob pass did work, and Isaiah was able to get under it and just beat the defender for the ball.
Really a nice job. We had one-on-one with Isaiah Garcia, and that's an automatic mismatch in our favor. And so really threw it to the back of the end zone, let Isaiah go up and pull it out of the air. Great, great job by the Panther offense to come back from a silly penalty
for the score. Triple R welding scoring play for the Panthers. Isaiah Garcia with a big touchdown catch. And here's the extra point try. It's a low kick again, and it's good. 21-6, Triple R Welding PAT. The M&J Fast Lube scoring update, 21-6 Fort Stockton. We'll be back in a moment.
The Oasis Truck Tire Center is your home-owned and operated truck and heavy equipment tire center in Fort Stockton. They offer many brands of quality tires and have many in stock to fit 18-wheelers, heavy pickups, and other heavy equipment. If they don't have exactly the right tire, they can get it for you quickly. See Chase Wiest and the professional staff at the Oasis Truck Tire Center in Fort Stockton on Highway 18, the Monahans Highway, just north of Interstate 10 in Fort Stockton. Call 432-336-7748.
M&J Trucking Services supports our Fort Stockton Panther and Prowler athletic teams and wants you to know that there's a locally owned and operated oilfield trucking company that can handle your vacuum truck and water hauling in the surrounding area. It's M&J Trucking in Fort Stockton, offering 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week vacuum truck and water hauling service. Contact M&J Trucking today at 290-4510. M&J Trucking, owned and operated by Martine Ibarra, proudly supporting the Fort Stockton Panthers and Prowlers.
All right, we are back, and the Panthers have just scored again. So what is it, 3 second quarter touchdowns?
It really is.
I think that's right. So, and 3 PATs by Aiden Villarreal. So 21-6 now, Panthers leading Crane. Here's the kickoff by Villarreal, and Crane muffs the kickoff, and then they will get back on it. So that's the second time in a row that Trey Larson has had a bit of a rough time returning the ball. Last time he fumbled it back to the Panthers. This time he muffs it and really has kind of a hard time getting back on top of the ball, but he does, and he's down at about the 19-yard line.
Well, and knowing that his name is Trey Larson, he's got at least one more mistake in him. I would say.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Yeah.
Well, let's get, you know, don't let them score before half. Let's go ahead and, you know, maybe use our timeouts even if we get a stop.
Okay, the ball is at the 19-yard line of Crane, first and 10. I formation, pitch out. And here's Galindo with the carry. And he's going to be brought down by the Panthers, Jadrian Ramirez, and also Darren Uresti. Bring him down. After a gain of about five on the play, maybe six. I guess it's about six up to the 25-yard line.
We were really ripping at the ball there, trying to force the turnover here before half.
Second down and four for the Golden Cranes. There's only 24 seconds left. I believe they're going to probably just go into the locker room here, but they're in no hurry, it looks like. I formation. Here's the pitch out. Fumble. And then the running back, Galindo, picks it back up. They fumble the ball, and it's back to the 22-yard line. That's a loss of about 3 yards, and that's going to be the end of the first half. Nope, somebody calls a timeout. 1 second left on the clock. There's actually Galindo lost his helmet. So are we going to go into the locker room? That's the key question here. Galindo lost his helmet. And now, that'll be the end of the first half. All right, it is M&J Fast Loop score update is Fort Stockton 21, Crane 6 at the end of the half. We'll be back with more Panther football in a moment.
Looking for home cooking away from home? Sagebrush Cafe at 2003 West Dickinson is your answer. Mondays, try their chicken fried steak special for only $6.99. Tuesdays, it's the specialty burger and fries and wing special Wednesday. They serve the best breakfast around, and they serve it all day long. Easy Press, now open Monday through Friday, 7:30 a.m. until 6 p.m.
Weiss Tire Incorporated is your family-owned and operated tire store serving Fort Stockton and West Texas for over 35 years with a friendly staff and unparalleled customer service. They're your authorized Firestone and Bridgestone tire dealer, but offer many brands, most in stock. They offer speedy repair and tire installation with wheel balancing and alignment along with rotations. They can also do brake jobs and other minor auto repair. Go by Weiss Tire today at 701 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton or call 432-336-3344. Dickinson in Fort Stockton or call 432-336-3344. Designer Carpets and Interiors has become known in Fort Stockton as the remodeling experts. They will be glad to put together a free estimate on just about any remodeling project, always keeping in mind your budget. They also can help with ideas and designs for your project to upgrade your home and add to its value. They also have all types of the latest and most modern flooring, including carpet, tile, hardwood, laminates, custom cabinetry, countertops, and much more. Call Designer Carpets and Interiors today at 336-6591. Pepito's Cafe in Fort Stockton is known far and wide for its great selection of authentic Mexican food and fabulous American food, too. They're open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. till 9 p.m. Go by and sample Roy's Big Burger, the most delicious in town, or tortas, tampiqueñas, shrimp cocktails, aguas frescas, and horchata. They feature drive-thru window service, too, and feature menudo on Saturdays and Sundays and serve breakfast all day. Pepito's Cafe, great food for all taste at 2014 West Dickinson. For orders to go, call 336-2882. Permian Basin Abstract Company is located at 600 West Dickinson and is available to handle all your real estate closings. They have a full-service title company and are experts at handling all the tricky parts of title work. Great customer service is their number one goal with local manager Penny McKnight. Permian Basin Abstract has locations in Andrews, Seminole, Pecos, and the local office in Fort Stockton to serve all area West Texas counties and have all records available. Call 432-336-3301 or go by Permian Basin Abstract, corner of Monahans Highway and Dickinson Boulevard.
Cactus Health is your one-stop health care facility. They care. They offer quality health care for you and your family, including cardiovascular disease care, cholesterol screenings, developmental screenings, diabetes care, family planning, HIV testing, and general primary medical care. Your family is their number one concern. They care. Cactus Health at 700 North Main. Call 336-8110 for information. Triple R Welding, located at 2215 West 9th, is here for all your residential, commercial, or oil field needs. From roustabout, hotshot, and certified welding to building and installing your own personalized one-of-a-kind fence and entrance. Bring them your ideas and they can make it happen. Call 336-5289. Triple R Welding. They can weld anything except a broken heart and the crack of dawn. Visit them today at 2215 West 9th Street. Or call 336-5289.
All right, we're back with our halftime show here. We've got the Crane, Golden Crane Band about to perform out there. They're taking more time to set up the show, it looks like, than most bands take to perform the entire show.
Well, if you look down, quite a few of them have been waiting so long to play, they fell asleep right in the middle of the field.
Yeah, how about that? Okay, let's take a look at the stats. Thanks to Daryl Scott for our numbers man for getting our stats.
Rain Man.
Yes, and Darren, I don't know if you want to, you know, okay, let's talk about the offense here. Crane has 45 total yards, Fort Stockton 167. And so Crane ran 18 plays. We ran 39, so that's more than double the number of plays Fort Stockton had than Crane had, Daryl.
Yeah, we controlled the ball once we got our feet underneath us. We just controlled it and kept running.
Well, and, you know, it was the second quarter where we really got things going and corrected our mistakes and, you know, got the lead in the ball game. And from then on, it was, you know, pretty much all Panthers, right? So that's an average of 2.5 yards per play for Crane, 4.3 yards for the Panthers. With the passing game, Crane 2 out of 5, and that's for how many, 5 yards?
Total of 10 yards.
Oh, okay.
Receiving yards.
Oh, okay, 10 yards. 2 out of 5 with a 5-yard average per pass. Fort Stockton, 7 out of 10 for, I believe, how many yards?
2.7 and a total of 19 yards. We had our first pass play, I think we took about a 20-yard loss on it.
Yeah. Fort Stockton, 148 yards rushing. Crane, 35 yards rushing. So the Panther defense, again, doing a great job. It's just that one touchdown, of course, that we allowed one pretty good running play by Crane, and the touchdown pass. Those were the two big plays for Crane, right?
Yeah, we set them up with a turnover.
And let's see what else. Two turnovers for Crane now and one for Fort Stockton. So that is good news that we just have one turnover, you know, so far in this game.
Yeah, we're better than our average.
Better than the average right now. All right, the scoring plays, of course, Crane drew blood first in the second quarter with 10-12 to go. Keaton Senna, a pass was complete to Trey Larson in the end zone. At least that's the way the officials ruled it. Some people have said that that ball was bobbled. Darren thought it was before, and he was out of bounds before he had control of it. But, you know, the official was not in the greatest position to make the call, and he ruled it a touchdown of 13 yards. And the extra point was blocked and almost returned by the Panthers for 2 points, but couldn't get it all the way downfield. Next in the second quarter, Fort Stockton answered right back with 8:23 to go in the second period. Corbin Luna ran for 4 yards for a touchdown. A point after by Aiden Villarreal was good, and we led 7-6. And then Corbin Luna, with 2:45 left, ran for 2 yards and a touchdown. Again, the extra point was a really good-looking extra point on that kick, and the Panthers led 14-6. And then, Darrell, I believe the next drive, was it this last one here that paid off after a turnover by Crane?
After a turnover and two touchdowns called back, one Corbin Lunan rushing play, I think, and also a pass, but we still put it in.
And, of course, that was the turnover was caused, I believe, on a big hit on the return man, right?
Right.
And we cashed that in for a touchdown. So that was with 55 seconds left in the first half. Marco Garcia, his pass was complete to Isaiah Garcia, number 11, for 19 yards and a touchdown. And the extra point was good again by Aiden Villarreal. So that's where we are right now at a 21-6 halftime lead. All right, the Crane Band playing out there right now. And so we've got a 21-6 lead. That's the M&J Fast Loop score update at halftime. We'll be back in just a moment.
The Guadalajara Mexican Grill in Fort Stockton features authentic Jalisco-style Mexican food with friendly and fast service. They're open starting at 8 a.m. for breakfast daily until 9:30 each night, Tuesday through Thursday, and until 10 p.m. Friday through Sunday. They also feature delicious Mexican desserts along with beer, piña coladas, margaritas, and micheladas with great specials every day. The Guadalajara Mexican Grill at 200 East 19th in Fort Stockton on the Imperial Highway.
Stockton Glass and Mirror is locally owned and operated and welcomes you to give them a call for a free estimate on any job. They're your premier commercial and residential glass installation company, proudly serving the Trans-Pecos and Big Bend for more than 30 years. Stockton Glass and Mirror offers quality glass products professionally installed, along with broken glass repair, shower enclosures, and much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. till noon and 1 to 5 p.m. Call 432-336-3152 or go by 202 East 5th.
Porky's Ice House in Fort Stockton is the place to get your drinks and snacks in Fort Stockton, with two convenient drive-thru lanes, and they're open 7 days a week for teas, lemonades, and fountain drinks with added flavors upon request and much more. Go by Porky's Ice House. Remember, happy hour is each day from 3 to 6 p.m. with all drinks any size for just a dollar. They also make popular Clamato, Squirt, Topo Chico, and Jerky Preparados that are delicious, along with nachos. Porky's Ice House, 1401 West Dickinson. Here's an excellent business opportunity in the Fort Stockton area. Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty now has a great office building, warehouse, and yard for lease at 1301 West 9th Street. The office building is nice and modern and comes fully furnished with two storage buildings and the industrial yard attached. To lease this property, please contact Angie Miles with Turnkey Realty. Go by her office at 804 North Main Street or call 432-290-8038. The Water Factory, located at 1005 North Butts in Fort Stockton, is your answer to premium drinking water and ice. For all your home or office cooler needs in Fort Stockton, it's the Water Factory. They have bottle and bulk delivery of purified water, and they even offer custom labeling for small bottles. They've been your water conditioning professionals since 1985. Call the Water Factory today, 336-6434, or go by 1005 North Butts. That's the Water Factory, Fort Stockton.
Feeling a little sluggish, weak, tired? It could be a vitamin B12 deficiency. The Salcetta Family Medicine and Urgent Care is offering vitamin B12 injections at no cost. That's right, no cost. No appointment needed. Go by at 703 North Main, Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. and talk with them about getting a free B12 injection today. Concept Inc. is here to help you with all your oil field and residential needs. They provide licensed septic system installations, site evaluations, roll-off container rentals, and porta-potty rentals, septic tank and grease trap pump-outs. Backhoe services and general construction also available. Contact Kobe Tarosses at 432-290-3620. That phone number again is 432-290-3620. Concept Inc.
Hey folks, have you got a vehicle sitting around that needs repair, but you don't want to pay the towing fee to the shop? Well, Alamo Tire and Auto Repair has solved that problem. They will come and pick up your vehicle at no charge. Then they will give you a free estimate on the repair if your repairs are done at Alamo Tire and Auto Repair. They offer complete auto repair with an ASE automotive electrical technician on staff. Alamo Tire and Auto Repair at 1673 West Alamo Road in the Alamo Ranchettes. Call 432-242-7092.
Are your insurance rates too high? At Fort Stockton Insurance, you're not stuck. We can shop within our own carriers to find the best deals. Do you know that we do more than property and auto? We do life, commercial, farm, and specialty insurance. Do you want to run on the field with the Baylor Bears, have an aerolite plane or a vintage vehicle? We insure all of that. Need a bond or commercial insurance? We can help you there, too. This is Pam at Fort Stockton Insurance. We're located at 901 West Dickinson, or give us a call at 336-8565.
Vehicle state inspections are valuable, but often painfully inconvenient. After you figure out where to get an inspection, it's even more painful to figure out when the inspector will be there. Well, at CTG Express in Fort Stockton, if the doors are open, it's inspection time. At CTG Express, we have a team of certified state inspectors instead of just one, so you get a fast, friendly, and thorough state inspection when you need it, with the confidence to know when you pull up, the answer at CTG Express is, yes, we can inspect your vehicle. And we're pretty incredible at oil changes, too.
Fort Stockton ISD Public Schools shape the future by providing the best possible education for our students. Hello, this is Dr. Gabe Zamora, superintendent. Together, we are ensuring that the future of our community, state, and nation is bright. Fort Stockton ISD is committed to bettering the future for all members of our school community. We are extremely proud of all our students and their accomplishments. For this reason, we are pleased to sponsor Fort Stockton High School sports broadcasts for those unable to attend. Go Panthers and Prowlers!
All right, we're back here at halftime, and we're going to have the Pride of Pantherland Band coming on in just a few moments. Crane Band has finished their halftime show, and so we're going to have the Pride of Pantherland Band on the air here in just a few moments, and we'll bring you the audio best we can from Panther Stadium. We've got a 21-6 halftime score. That's your M&J Fast Lube score update. And we'll be back in just a moment with more Panther football.
Truckloads of brand new 2022s are rolling in during Ram Power Days at Ram Country Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Fort Stockton. I'm talking about truckloads of Ram 1500s, 2500s, and 3500s. This is your chance to get huge savings with 0% financing for 72 months on a great selection of Ram trucks. Plus, get Ram Country's exclusive warranty forever at no extra charge. Hurry to Ram Country in Fort Stockton and get huge savings with 0% 6 years interest-free financing. It's incredible, but you gotta hurry. These brand new 2022 Ram trucks will be gone in no time, and it's a great time to trade in your old truck, because we're paying top dollar for every trade-in cash on the spot. It's Power Days at Ram Country in Fort Stockton. It's time to save big on a big selection of Ram 1500 Lone Star and Laramies with 0% for 72 months. No games, no gimmicks, just great deals at Ram Country Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. Call 888-389-2710 for details.
When you need supplies in the oil field, the choice is clear. Choose Triple G Supply and Services in Fort Stockton. They have all the oil field supplies you need, including general oil field supplies, PVC pipe and fittings, hydraulic hoses, generators, safety equipment, household supplies, and much more. They also have roustabout services available. Triple G Supply and Services is right here in Fort Stockton at the west end of Dickinson at 1048 Crockett Avenue. Delivery is available to your location. Call 336-8284 Triple G Supply and Services.
Is this the year you finally put a patio in your backyard? If so, then call the pros at Big Bend Concrete. Concrete is among the most popular of all the hardscaping materials. It's durable, versatile, lasts a long time. And when you compare concrete to the many other materials you'll find, it's very cost effective. Plus, concrete stands up to tough Texas weather. Unlike wood, you won't have to worry about warping or rotting. So when you're ready to get her done, then call Big Bend Concrete. Solid.
Doctors Josh Pass, Brian Cherry, and Hewlin Pass are optometrists serving the West Texas area. Visit West Texas Eye Care at 605 North Main in Fort Stockton or 611 South Oak in Pecos. They offer complete and thorough eye examinations for the whole family, including therapeutic optometry, eyeglasses, contact lenses, laser surgery consultation, and screenings for macular degeneration and diabetes with an in-office lab. Call to make an appointment today in Fort Stockton at 336-3662 or in Pecos 445-3662.
Friday, September 16th through Thursday, September 22nd, Panther Pictures will be showing Paws of Fury at the theater located at the Convention Center. A down-on-his-luck hound finds himself in a town full of cats who need a hero to defend them from a ruthless villain's evil plot. With help from a reluctant trainer, the underdog must assume the role of fearsome samurai and save the day. Everyone's invited to this animated film at Panther Pictures in Fort Stockton.
All right, we're back here at halftime, and we've got the Pride of Pantherland Band about to enter the field here. And speaking of Panther Pictures, we just told you about the movie they're showing this week. But they've also got the fifth quarter out there at the Convention Center. And that'll be tonight following the Panther football game.
And they've been showing they've been showing some clips from the Panther games.
You've been going to some of those, haven't you?
I went to that.
Yeah. And that's Aaron Owens' production, is that right?
I believe it is an Aaron Owens production.
Yeah. So the Pride of Pantherland Band about to take the field, and we're going to carry them here on Fort Stockton's KFST. AM 860, KFST 94.3 FM, also on KFSTradio.com tonight. Whole bunch of ways to pick us up. You can also pick us up on Facebook Live. Punch in KFST, and I'm sure you'll be able to search for that and bring it up. And also, we're on YouTube. And you can also search for KFST there, and I think you can pull our channel up on YouTube as well. All right, here's the Pride of Pantherland coming up.
Good evening, Panther fans. Please join me in welcoming to the field the Pride of Pantherland, the mighty Panther marching band.
Thank you.
Darren. This is a show entitled Olay. It's a great show, very entertaining.
It really is. Did you hear the guitar player, the flute?
Yeah, they were great.
I love
it. Very nice.
Makes you want to go out and fight a bull. Well, I don't want to fight one.
Well,
that's
a great job by the Pride of Pantherland band. Thanks a lot from the Pride of Pantherland. We're at halftime, and it's Fort Stockton 21, Crane 6. We'll be back after this.
Fort Stockton High School Panther football is brought to you by Buck's Lube Center, Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, the Pecos County State Bank, Cassie Ledesma State Farm Insurance, D&L Well Service, Amistad Motors, the Steakhouse Restaurant, Farmers Insurance Agent Adelina Salazar, the First National Bank, Adonis Sanitation, B3 Properties, Rainwater Motor Company, Sawyer Insurance, Citibank, K-Bob Steakhouse, Heritage Funeral Home, M&J Fast Lube, Julie's Easy Press, M&J Trucking, the Oasis Truck Tire Center, the Sagebrush Cafe, and Lowe's Marketplace. Also by Weiss Tire, Designer Carpets and Interiors, Pepito's Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, Cactus Health Services, Triple R Welding, the Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Porky's Ice House, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, the Water Factory, Salceda Family Medicine, Alamo Tire and Auto Repair, Concept Inc., CTG Express, Fort Stockton Insurance, Fort Stockton ISD, Ram Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Big Ben Concrete, West Texas Eye Care, and by Panther Pictures.
Looking for home cooking away from home? Sagebrush Cafe at 2003 West Dickinson is your answer. Mondays, try their chicken fried steak special for only $6.99. Tuesdays, it's the specialty burger and fries and wing special Wednesday. They serve the best breakfast around, and they serve it all day long. Sagebrush Cafe offers many other menu items like catfish, salads, and Mexican food also. Stop by for a beer, wine, or mixed drink. Sagebrush Cafe, 2003 West Dickinson, for home-cooked food away from home.
All right, Darren, we're back at halftime, and we're still waiting on the field to be cleared so we can start the second half. Looks like there may have been an injury on one of the band members.
That's what it looks like.
Maybe.
We've got somebody down across the way. And
they're bringing on the Gator to take care of that person. Anyway, Darren, in the meantime, if you have any scores to pass along, go ahead.
I've got it. We've got some interesting scores. I know we looked at San Angelo Central, who I never can get right. They're beating Belton 28-12. We've also got Friendship over Abilene 14-7. That's in the third quarter. My wife's Midland Bulldogs are leading Lubbock Monterey 6-0 in the second quarter. Amarillo Sandys, what a sis name, is leading the Odessa Broncos 35-3 at halftime. Also, Cibolo Steel is leading Midland Leg 14-7. That's some of our 6A scores. Over to 5A Division I. Don't have anything on the Clint Lions yet. They're playing, but be a little bit later. Caprock lost to Canyon 35-32 in a close game. Abilene Cooper knocks off Lubbock Coronado in a bit of an upset, 33-28. Wichita Falls Ryder, who is favored, is losing to Lubbock Cooper 10-0. That is in the third quarter. Let's see, Amarillo Tascosa 42, Hereford 3. That's at halftime. And let's see as we go down to 5A Division 2 if we've got any scores of interest. Lakeview, I believe this was yesterday. They beat Lubbock Westerners 35-21. We've also got Dumas over Plainview, 36-6. Kyle will be happy. Here's a great game. Stephenville and Abilene Wiley are tied 28-28, and that is at halftime. Down to 4A Division I. That was the division we used to be in. Let's see. We've got Big Spring and Sweetwater, 7-7 in the second quarter, and I don't think Sweetwater's as good as they used to be. Estacado all over Leveland at halftime, 27-0. A very good game, surprisingly, maybe not too surprising. Andrews 15, Seminole 14, and that is at halftime. Brownwood leading Glen Rose 3-0. And that's also almost halftime. And let's see, Pampa losing to Decatur 28-0. Now, in our division, 4A Division II, we've got the Pecos Eagles are leading Stanton Buffalo 7-0, and that's at the start of the third quarter. Of course, our score, Fort Stockton 21, Crane 6 at halftime, fixing to get started. Monahan's all over Snyder 35-7 at halftime. That's surprising that it's that wide of a margin. Canadian over Perryton 42-0. Bushland over Borger, 35-7. Midland Greenwood is leading Shallow Water at halftime, 30-14, and that's that's a little bit of a surprise. Shallow Water's been beating up on most of these bigger schools.
Yeah.
As we move on down to 3A Division One, Kermit over Midland TLC. I don't know how many TLC teams are out there now, but quite a few. It's 47-0 at halftime. Nothing on Denver City at this point. Lubbock Roosevelt over Slayton, 21-14 in the third. Littlefield over La Mesa at halftime, 20-0. Brownfield all over Dimmitt at halftime, 41-3. Muleshoe, 30-6 over Tulia.
One of the things I was very interested in, Monahans looks like they're going to get their first win tonight of the season. But, man, what a showing that they're having over Snyder, 35-7 right now.
Well, it is. And I didn't think Snyder was that strong. I looked at it and I'm not sure. It's hard to tell early in the season. You know, I thought Crane outplayed us in the first quarter, and they took a 6-0 lead after a turnover by Fort Stockton. But Fort Stockton has really played an excellent second quarter to lead 21-6. So you never know. Crane looks pretty solid, though.
And, Darren, did you get the Forsan McCamey score?
Go ahead and give that. I know Forsan, I think, was winning 13-2 maybe?
Yeah, they're winning 13-2 at halftime over McCamey right now.
Well, I knew Nacho. I saw him down there crying. I wasn't sure what happened, but that must be it.
All right, so we'll take a break here on KFST. We got the second half kickoff coming up.
Designer Carpets and Interiors has become known in Fort Stockton as the remodeling experts. They will be glad to put together a free estimate on just about any remodeling project, always keeping in mind your budget. They also can help with ideas and designs for your project to upgrade your home and add to its value. They also have all types of the latest and most modern flooring, including carpet, tile, hardwood, laminates, custom cabinetry, countertops, and much more. Call Designer Carpets and Interiors today at 336-6591. Permian Basin Abstract Company has the experts ready to help everyone with their real estate closings at 600 West Dickinson. With locations in Andrews, Seminole, Pecos, and Fort Stockton, they have complete real estate records, including every record filed in Pecos, Reeves, Loving, Gaines, and Andrews counties, along with mineral records. They welcome landmen and surveyors for research. Great customer service is their number one goal at Permian Basin Abstract. Open Monday through Friday and during the lunch hour from 8 a.m. till 5 p.m. At the corner of Dickinson and the Monahans Highway in Fort Stockton, call 336-3301. Pepito's Cafe in Fort Stockton is known far and wide for its great selection of authentic Mexican food and fabulous American food, too. They're open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. till 9 p.m. Go by and sample Roy's Big Burger, the most delicious in town, or tortas, tampiqueñas, shrimp cocktails, aguas frescas, and horchata. They feature drive-through window service, too, and feature menudo on Saturdays and Sundays and serve breakfast all day. Pepito's Cafe, great food for all taste at 2014 West Dickinson. For orders to go, call 336-2882.
Cactus Health is your one-stop health care facility. They care, offering quality health care for you and your family, including health education, hearing screenings, adult and children immunizations, minor x-rays, postpartum care, OB care, prenatal services, men's and women's health, and lab services. Cactus Health, located at 700 North Main Street. Call 336-8110 for information and appointments.
All right, we're about to kick off the second half. Finally, it was a long halftime break. Almost like a halftime break in a college football game, right?
I know, and you know, I'm gonna penalize Crane. I think they were stalling. They had one of their band members staying down late, but no, we hope they're okay.
One of ours
wasn't ours. Oh, okay, yeah, we hope they're okay. But they did bring out the cart, so hopefully everyone's okay. It was a great halftime performance by the Fort Stockton band.
Yes, and Crane, they did a great job as well. Of course, they're both getting ready for that important UIL contest. Okay, we've got Fort Stockton kicking off to the Golden Cranes. Aiden Villarreal kicking off against the wind tonight. And here's a squib kick, and it rolls at the 20, gets by the Golden Cranes. There's a fumble, and it goes out of bounds. Pedro Gonzalez hit the return man, who was Carlos Garcia.
Wow.
And, you know, the squib kick took an interesting bounce. And it just really bounced away from that return man, went by him, and kind of bounced over his head, and he couldn't get a hold of it. and then he fumbled it. Yep. And fortunately for Crane, it went out of bounds before we got on top of it.
Yeah, it's a live ball, and he realized when it took the bad hop over his head that we had a couple of guys racing towards the ball, and he tried to pick it up, got hit, and it went out of bounds.
Well, Crane is backed up to their 8-yard line after that mistake. And so here's the Golden Cranes up under center. Three backs in the backfield. So they're going to bring in an extra blocker to try to get their running game going. And that time, Darren, they'll gain a yard, maybe two. I believe it's a 2-yard gain. Well, we'll see where they mark it. It's about a 1-yard gain. Second and 9, the ball at the 9-yard line for Crane.
Yeah, Fort Stockton defense has been tough. Really a one long pass play that was very close. At the back of the end zone, very close. But Panther defense has played well.
I don't know if Crane went to the 3-back set just because they were deep in their own territory or if that was their plan, you know, coming out of the locker room. It's a wishbone.
It is.
For Crane with the quarterback up under center on 2nd and 9. And there's a fumble on the play. And I believe number 5, the running back, got back on it, and that is Brian Galindo. But that's a loss back to the 2-yard line, and it's 3rd down and about 16.
I think they've got him closer to the 1.
Yeah.
It is really back there, so nice job by our defense. Crane, after some early success in the first quarter, I tell you, our defensive line has been pushing them back, and they're starting to make some mistakes.
I tell you, shout out again to Tristan Barragon, who is running our camera tonight. And, we wanted to get the video on Facebook this year, and we've done it. And Tristan has done such a great job with our camera. Here's a long pass downfield. It is just over the outstretched hands of Trey Larson. Man, it was close, but it's incomplete. 4th down and long for Crane.
Well, they'll have to be. We have a chance to block this. They're not going to have their usual lineup on the punt, so we came pretty close to blocking a punt. Let's see if we can get a hand on this and maybe get a safety or a touchdown.
So we're glad to be on Facebook Live this year and on YouTube. That's adding a lot to our broadcast this year. And people can go back and watch it, too. The punter lined up deep in his own end zone, and here's a punt that gets a good roll. Isaiah Garcia takes it at the 48-yard line, and he is weaving down to the 30, and that's where he's going to be stopped at the 30, maybe the 31. So that'll be a return down to the 31-yard line for Isaiah Garcia.
Really a nice job to come up. That ball took off on the hit. And they are punting with the wind, so it shot forward, and Isaiah did a nice job of not letting it roll and roll and roll. He picked it up and went down.
And, Darren, one thing that I would like to see the Panthers improve on is points in the second half.
Well, that's been a tough thing. And so we can change a lot of that with a touchdown right here on this drive.
Yeah, we really need to start the second half off with a positive drive, and let's do that right now. 1st and 10. Marco Garcia in the shotgun, flanker on the left. Here's the handoff to number 13. There's a flag coming in. That may be a face mask. And that's down to the 25-yard line for the running back, Isaiah Velasquez.
Really a strong run. And it is great. We have internet radio. We have Facebook. We have YouTube. I've got all kinds of family in Dallas watching the game,
yeah,
critiquing your performance. They really liked mine, but they said you're going to have to pick it up.
That is a face mask violation on Crane, and so that's going to give Fort Stockton a Rainwater Motor Company 1st down, and it's going to be moved down near the 10-yard line, just outside about the 13, and it'll be 1st and 10 right there.
Well, our offensive line has really been whipping Crane for the last quarter and a half, so let's punch it in.
All right, 1st down and 10 for the Panthers at about the 13. Marco will hand it off, and sweeping around to the right side, very speedy back right there. And I don't think he scored, but that's a great move. Isaiah Velasquez showing a lot of speed around the right side, and he's down to the 1-yard line. That's a 12-yard pickup and a Rainwater Motor Company 1st and goal. Also, that's an M&J Trucking Company outstanding play.
Really is. Fort Stockton lining up quickly. We've got a lot of momentum. Let's not make any mistakes and punch it in.
1st and goal, Marco in the shotgun. And it's a pretty high snap, and he Crane was penetrating through the offensive line very quickly. That's a loss of about a yard on the play at least, as Crane broke through the offensive line that time, and, man, they were right there at the handoff. That's a loss of two, actually. So it's second and goal from the three.
I think a little bit of a high snap made that play, maybe threw the timing off just a bit on that running play.
I think that's right, yep. Bit of a high snap. So second and goal from the three-yard line.
We've got our now change. Isaiah's under center at quarterback.
Isaiah Velasquez is the quarterback up under center. He pitches it out to Jadrian Ramirez. Jadrian is going to be stopped at around the two-yard line, a gain of one for Jadrian. So a different different quarterback that time.
That's kind of that pitch play. We put Isaiah Velasquez under center. Mm-hmm. He takes the snap, immediately pitches it to the running back, and becomes the lead blocker. And we scored on that play earlier.
So it's third and goal now from the two-yard line. An I formation with Luna and Jadrian in the I. And here's Velasquez. He pitches it back. It's a touchdown to Jadrian Ramirez on the pitch out. The option around the right side scores the touchdown from 2 yards away. And that's a Triple R Welding Panther touchdown.
Really a nice job, good blocking. You know, they were penetrating up the middle. He's able to get outside quickly and really got a little bit of a hit right at the goal line, but bounced in.
All right, Aiden Villarreal will be kicking the extra point. Marco Garcia, the holder on the play. Let's see if Adrian can make it 4-for-4 tonight. It's a good snap. Oh, that's partially blocked. So the PAT fails, and the M&J Fast Lube score update. Fort Stockton 27, Crane 6. Back in a moment.
Triple R Welding, located at 2215 West 9th, is here for all your residential, commercial, or oil field needs. From roustabout, hotshot, and certified welding to building and installing your own personalized one-of-a-kind fence and entrance. Bring them your ideas, and they can make it happen. Call 336-5289. Triple R Welding. They can weld anything except a broken heart and the crack of dawn. Visit them today at 2215 West 9th Street or call 336-5289.
The Guadalajara Mexican Grill in Fort Stockton features authentic Jalisco-style Mexican food with friendly and fast service. They're open starting at 8 a.m. for breakfast daily until 9:30 each night, Tuesday through Thursday, and until 10 p.m. Friday through Sunday. They also feature delicious Mexican desserts along with beer, piña coladas, margaritas, and micheladas with great specials every day. The Guadalajara Mexican Grill at 200 East 19th in Fort Stockton on the Imperial Highway.
And we're back for the Panther kickoff now after the Panthers took their first possession. Had good field position to start that drive, Darren, and we scored the touchdown. The extra point failed. So it's now 27-6. Score update brought to you by M&J Fast Loop.
Yeah, great defensive stand, a nice punt return, and the Panthers punch it in.
And here's the kickoff by Aiden Villarreal, taken at the 24-yard line by Crane. Wow, they'll take a knee.
Well, you know what?
That's weird.
I thought he signaled and took off. I think that's a penalty.
Well, so. Did he take a knee? Anyway, that's Angel Reyes on the return, and I thought he caught it, started running with it, and then took a knee at the 25.
I'm not sure. Well.
That's interesting. Maybe they are afraid they'll fumble again on the return, but with a big hit by Fort Stockton. I'm not sure why they did that.
Maybe. I don't know.
Okay, it's first down and 10. Ball at the 25-yard line of Crane. Split backfield this time. They get out of that wishbone. A receiver on each side. And the quarterback is Keaton Senna, number 12, I believe. And he will hand it off. Fort Stockton, great defense. They might have gained 1 yard up to the 26-yard line. I believe they did, and it's going to be second and 9.
Really, the defense is, as the game has progressed, the defense has played better and better.
Brian Galindo on the carry for 1 yard at second and 9.
I know we had fans in, South Korea last week?
Week before? we sure did.
Listening, I know.
We've always got a listener from Russia. I don't know what the deal is with that.
Well, that's you and Putin are close.
Okay, second down and 9, split backfield. Fake handoff, and now the long pass downfield is going to be overthrown. Intended for Trey Larson, the guy who caught the touchdown for Crane. Ethan Acosta, pretty good single coverage right there on the receiver.
Yeah, he's trying to sell that he was grabbed, but he wasn't grabbed.
He's complaining to that downfield official big time.
Yeah, when the ball was overthrown too, he wasn't grabbed. He just couldn't catch up with it, so he pretended like he was grabbed. Good acting, but no Oscar tonight.
Well, we have the Texas Longhorns taking on UTSA's Roadrunners tomorrow. I believe that's 7 o'clock kickoff, broadcast time at 6. And the Aggies will take on Miami tomorrow night, a late game. 7 o'clock is the broadcast time, 8 o'clock kickoff. Flag coming in.
I think they moved when they set, so I think they're going to go back. I just got a text from
dead ball foul, illegal substitution on Crane.
Just got a text from Russia, somebody named Vladimir Ripley says, shout out to Russia. So that's that explains a lot.
Okay. Vlad Ripley. Okay.
Owns a radio station, as a matter of fact, there.
Third down and 14. And they're getting ideas from us. Ball at the 21, third and 14. Split backfield. Here's the screen pass for Crane. Panthers read it beautifully. It was complete.
Wow.
But Jadrian Ramirez was right there, and that's a loss of a yard on the screen pass play.
Really did a nice job. A lot of pressure on the quarterback. He had to flip it out early, and Jadrian was not fooled. He was right there. Now, if they'd have got him blocked, that could have gone for a pretty good gain.
So it's fourth down, ball at the 21-yard line, fourth and 14 for the Golden Cranes. 6:38 remaining, third quarter. And here's the punt. Man, that was a lot of pressure that time on the punt. The punt will roll out of bounds in Fort Stockton territory, right around, I would say, the 44-yard line. We'll see.
That was close to getting blocked.
All right, they're going to rule it at the 42-yard line, and that'll be Fort Stockton ball right there. We'll take over, and Fort Stockton has outscored Crane 6-0 here in the second half, and we have an M&J Fast Lube game score update. Fort Stockton 27, Crane 6.
I don't think we've scored more than 6 points and a half in a second half this year. I think we scored, what, 3 in the first game? And maybe 6 the last 2 weeks.
Okay, first and 10, Panthers at our own 42. And here's Marco Garcia handing it off right up the middle to Isaiah Velasquez. First down run for Isaiah. That's going to be a 12-yard pickup for Isaiah Velasquez, an M&J Trucking Company outstanding play, and it's a Rainwater Motor Company first down.
Isaiah looks fast right now. He looks like he's really getting a full head of steam as he hits the line.
First down and 10 in Crane territory now at the 46 of the Golden Cranes. Single back is Corbin Luna. No, it's not. It's Velasquez still. Great cut by Isaiah Velasquez, and he's going to gain about 6 or 7, I believe, up to the 39-yard line. It's going to be 7 yards picked up, second and 3.
Again, I want to shout out Richard Rojas. You know, we miss you at the game. Get well and come back and see us soon.
Second down and 3 yards to go. Ball at the Crane 39. Shotgun for Marco Garcia. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. He shifts Velasquez to his right at running back. Garcia throws it downfield, puts a lot of arm into this one, and that's a catch by Isaiah Garcia. Down to the 7-yard line. Beautiful catch. And, he held up a little bit. The ball was a little bit underthrown. There's a Crane injury on the play. The guy who is guarding him, Alex Alvarez, comes up limping on the play. But another fantastic play by Marco Garcia down to Isaiah Garcia for the catch. And it's first and goal, Panthers. M&J Trucking Company, outstanding play. And Rainwater Motor Company, first and goal.
I think Crane saw we were running a hurry up, and I don't know. I think they saw, and they're stalling us right now.
Injury timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
Stockton Glass and Mirror is locally owned and operated and welcomes you to give them a call for a free estimate on any job. They're your premier commercial and residential glass installation company, proudly serving the Trans-Pecos and Big Bend for more than 30 years. Stockton Glass and Mirror offers quality glass products professionally installed, along with broken glass repair, shower enclosures, and much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. till noon and 1 to 5 p.m. Call 432-336-3152 or go by 202 East 5th.
Porky's Ice House in Fort Stockton is the place to get your drinks and snacks in Fort Stockton, with two convenient drive-thru lanes, and they're open 7 days a week for teas, lemonades, and fountain drinks with added flavors upon request and much more. Go by Porky's Ice House. Remember, happy hour is each day from 3 to 6 p.m. with all drinks any size for just a dollar. They also make popular Clamato, Squirt, Topo Chico, and Jerky Preparados that are delicious, along with nachos. Porky's Ice House, 1401 West Dickinson.
All right, we're back, and it's first and goal. Panthers at the 7. Here's the shotgun snap right up the middle, and it is Isaiah Velasquez with the touchdown, 7 yards. And the Panthers have scored two straight times on two straight possessions here in the second half. That's good to see.
Well, it is our highest scoring half now of the year, and really 2 for 2. We made some adjustments, I think, at halftime, and they're paying off.
High scoring second half.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yes, yes, high scoring second half.
All right, and here's Aiden Villarreal to attempt the kick with Marco Garcia as his holder. That's a Triple R Welding touchdown, and the kick might have been partially blocked, and it is no good. So it is 33-6, the M&J Fast Loop scoring update. We'll be back with more Panther football after this.
Your local real estate professional is Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, offering experienced, professional, knowledgeable, and friendly real estate consultation. Angie Miles has over 30 years of sales experience and serves the entire Trans-Pecos area, including Fort Stockton, Pecos, Alpine, and Southwest Texas. She can show any listing and can list your residential, commercial, or farm and ranch property, and also offers property management services. For all your real estate needs, contact Angie Miles with Turnkey Realty, 804 North Main, or call 290-8038.
The Water Factory, located at 1005 North Butts in Fort Stockton, is your answer to premium drinking water and ice. For all your home or office cooler needs in Fort Stockton, it's the Water Factory. They have bottle and bulk delivery of purified water, and they even offer custom labeling for small bottles. They've been your water conditioning professionals since 1985. Call the Water Factory today, 336-6434, or go by 1005 North Butts. That's the Water Factory, Fort Stockton.
All right, we're back here in the third quarter. 5:07 is left in the third. Fort Stockton looking good from a scoring standpoint here in this period. Two straight possessions and two straight touchdowns. But we have failed on the extra point tries both times. I think one of them was blocked for sure, and the other one I think partially blocked. And there's the return man for Crane being pushed out of bounds by Pedro Gonzalez, I believe. Angel Reyes, the return man for Crane. He's out of bounds at the 35-yard line.
Well, not bad. The line side, the line drive kick has been effective for us tonight.
Yeah. It's they've had some trouble picking it up at times.
Well, and the defense has really picked it up after that first quarter. They're shutting Crane down.
First down and 10 for the Golden Cranes. Receiver on each side for Crane, and they've got an I formation. Senna hands it off to the tailback, and that's a great tackle by Fort Stockton again. That's Jordan Franco in on the tackle for no gain. And it's going to be second and 10. Jordan Franco just right there for a great tackle.
Nice job. Our linebackers are very active. Really, our front seven have played very well.
Second down and 10 for Crane at the 35-yard line. This Panther defense is something to be reckoned with, huh?
Yeah, they're pretty tough.
We play El Paso Isleta on the road next week, right?
Yes, we do. Go Panthers.
Split backfield with a shotgun formation, a receiver on each side. And Crane will hand it off, coming around the left side, and it's Galindo. And that is Dominic Bernal on the tackle, and he's trying to rip the ball out. And also, I believe Jordan Franco might have been in on that tackle as well.
Oh, he didn't get the ball loose, but he pulled his arm out. So no, that's not – that's – never mind. That was just a bandage on the field. I thought, oh, my goodness, he pulled his arm off. Good job, Dominic. Nice tackle. Third and long again.
Well, each team has had just – well, let's see. Crane's had two turnovers. We've just had one. Is that right?
I think you are correct, Vlad.
Thank you. Third down and seven. I formation. Quarterback is back to throw, and he's down the sideline, and it's incomplete. I don't know if the receiver would have had enough room to make the catch inbounds or not, but there were, you know, two Panther defenders there by the time the pass arrived. And a pretty good job over there by, I believe it was Ethan Acosta and maybe Jadrian Ramirez on the coverage.
Yeah, nice job. But good pressure on the quarterback, and, hey, just – good coverage.
So Fort Stockton now, total yardage, 244 yards. Crane, just 42 yards tonight.
I think they had more in the first half, didn't they?
I think so, yeah. They had 43 or 4 at one time. Okay, here's Crane punting, and here's a nice return to punt. It's 22-yard line, but they will have a nice open field tackle, this time on Isaiah Garcia, who's out to the 29-yard line, about a 7-yard return. I thought that time that we might have had a better return, but it was a pretty good coverage kick. It was pretty high in the air.
Really was, and they guessed right. They guessed that he'd be going to his right, and he was. I think maybe had a little better angle to his left. But, let's have a 71-yard drive here.
First down and 10 for Fort Stockton at the 29-yard line in our own territory. Marco Garcia in the shotgun with Corbin Luna as the running back. I like the shifting of the running backs to give one a little bit of a rest. It's a pretty good strategy, and it's worked pretty well tonight. Here's Corbin Luna, and he's out to the left side and just weaving his way into the middle of the line with a little bit of a cutback run, and he's going to gain close to 7 yards at the 36. Nice gain for Corbin Luna, setting up second and 3.
Well, our running backs are really starting to find a lot of room to run. They're not getting hit till 3 or 4 or 5 yards down the field.
All right, we've got two receivers on the left, one on the right. Corbin Luna in the backfield, Marco Garcia in the shotgun. He takes the snap, pass out to the right flat, left flat, I'm sorry. That is a completed pass to Joel Orozco, I believe, number 23.
I believe you're right.
And Orozco has a completed pass for a Rainwater Motor Company first down at the 44-yard line.
Well, Panthers offense really looks good in this second half.
Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Garcia handing the ball off to Corbin. He backs his way through a couple of Crane defenders and now is across the 50 into Crane territory for close to another 7-yard gain. I believe it is 7.
Yeah, they spun him around, and then he just kept backing up and running over people.
So second and 3 for the Panthers. Good running, good passing on this drive.
Yeah, and Crane had shot the gap. They had a shot at him in the backfield, but he's able to elude that first tackler.
Two receivers on the left, one on the right. And here's the handoff again to Luna. He's got a first down, and strong running Luna power down to the 35-yard line. That's going to be a gain of about 14. An Eamon J. Trucking Company outstanding play, and it's a Rainwater Motor Company first down. There are two possible Crane guys down, one of them limping, and one of them, two limping. I mean, their Crane has got some problems right here on the defensive side of the ball with two guys limping off the field.
And they had three down at one time. They had another guy back upfield that was slow to get up. So really, Fort Stockton starting to pound and wear down this Crane defense.
33-6, Fort Stockton leading the Crane Golden Cranes. That's your M&J Fast Lube game score update. First and 10, ball at the 34 of the Golden Cranes. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Garcia in the shotgun. Pass in the flat, and the receiver was hit really before the ball ever arrived. And number 7, Carlos Garcia for Crane, made that defensive play.
Really did. They recognized the quick wide receiver screen and were able to get around the block and make a hit and break that up.
Second down and 10 now for the Panthers after the incomplete pass. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Garcia will hand the ball off, and it's Jadrian Ramirez right up the middle. He does a little pirouette, and he's down at the 17-yard line, but that's plenty of yardage for another Rainwater Motor Company first down.
You know, I'm going to be honest. Running backs don't want you to say they did a little pirouette. That's you know, could you come up with something better?
Who was the football player that took ballet lessons? Anyway, we're not going to.
I'm not sure.
All right, here's another flag coming in. Jadrian Ramirez on the run again. Inside the five, just keeps on going to the one-yard line. Man, Jadrian's showing a lot of power. And unfortunately, I believe it's going to be all for naught because there's a flag.
I don't know. I think they might have been offsides.
No, it's offsides against Crane. It is a big play for Jadrian Ramirez. That's an outstanding play brought to you by M&J Trucking Company. And that's a 16-yard pickup for a Rainwater Motor Company first and goal.
I like it.
Wow. That had a great run.
Yeah, really, he just kept on going.
He's mad that he didn't get in. I think if he knew you said little pirouette, he would have made it.
Single back. Here's Marco on the keeper, and he's got the touchdown. Marco Garcia with a one-yard keeper for the touchdown for Fort Stockton. And the Panthers increase their lead now to 39-6 on a Triple R Welding touchdown brought to you by Triple R Welding. And, of course, Marco Garcia, the sneak right around left tackle.
Very sneaky and effective.
Yeah. Boy, the Panthers have done a little bit of everything tonight, haven't they?
Well, you take care of the ball and avoid penalties, good things happen.
All right, now let's see if Aiden can get a kick without it being blocked. That one was blocked too, I believe. Yes, it was.
All right, 39-6 remains our score, and it's Fort Stockton leading, brought to you by M&J Fastlane. We'll be back in a moment.
Just kick it too low.
That's right, no cost, no appointment needed. We'll go by 703 North Bend.
We're doing okay over there?
Yes. About getting a free B12 injection today.
West Alamo Road in the Alamo Ranchettes. Call 432-242-7092.
Concept Inc. is here to help you with all your oil field and residential needs. They provide licensed septic system installations, site evaluations, roll-off container rentals, and porta-potty rentals, septic tank and grease trap pump-outs. Backhoe services and general construction also available. Contact Colby Tarosas at 432-290-3620. That phone number again is 432-290-3620. Concept Inc.
Are your insurance rates too high?
All right, we are back, and we may have had a technical issue there. I'm not quite sure what happened, but we had a return by Crane up to the 46-yard line.
Yeah, I think Ruben Falcone from Shallow Water reports that we had some mic echo.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm not sure what's going on, but I'll look at things and try to get things fixed here.
Hello.
All right. Here we go with a first and 10 for the Golden Cranes. And that is Galindo on the carry. He's going to have about 3 yards up to the 49-yard line in Crane territory.
Well, that's been maybe their best play in the second half. 3 yards on first down, a nice carry.
It is second down and 7.
So
that's going to be the end of the third period. So Fort Stockton is leading 39-6. That's the M&J Fast Lube score update at the end of 3, 39-6, Fort Stockton. Back in a moment.
Are your insurance rates too high? At Fort Stockton Insurance, you're not stuck. We can shop within our own carriers to find the best deals. Do you know that we do more than property and auto? We do life, commercial, farm, and specialty insurance. Do you want to run on the field with the Baylor Bears, have an aerolite plane or a vintage vehicle? We insure all of that. Need a bond or commercial insurance? We can help you there too. This is Pam at Fort Stockton Insurance. We're located at 901 West Dickinson, or give us a call at 336-8565.
CTG Express Oil Change in Fort Stockton is all about making you happy. Happy with a full-service oil change delivered in record time by CTG's friendly and professional staff. We're so happy about making you happy, we're making a happy hour. A three-hour-long happy hour from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. every weekday, where you get $15 off every full-service oil change. $15 off, 11 to 2 p.m. every weekday at your Fort Stockton CTG Express. We'll see you at happy hour.
All right, we're back with more Panther football here on KFST, AM and FM, KFSTradio.com. And the Fort Stockton Panthers now with 315 yards of total offense. Crane with just 45 total yards of offense at this point in the game.
I think that's what they had at the start of the half.
All right, here's Crane now. What happened right there?
Wow.
I was looking at something else, didn't see the play, Darren.
Well, what happened was Darren Uresti flew up from his linebacker spot and got a tackle for a loss of about 2 yards.
Okay.
So really a nice play. 2 or 3 yard loss on that play, tackled by Darren Uresti.
So it's 3rd down and 9 coming up for the Golden Cranes.
I think they're at negative yardage for the half, so they really haven't been able to do anything. And they're going against the wind here in the fourth quarter.
39-6, the Fort Stockton Panthers leading. That's the M&J Fast Lube score update. I formation, a receiver on the left side. Quarterback is rolling out. He's going to be sacked by Zane Hodges. Boy, that is a huge play by Zane coming off the left defensive end position. And that is a big sack for Zane on the quarterback, Senna, a loss of about 9 yards, I believe.
Yeah, he came flying through from his left defensive end, and they just missed their block, and the quarterback's rolling to his left. Never saw him, and Gus got buried.
Wow, it is 4th and very long now for the Golden Cranes, and Isaiah Garcia is back to receive the punt. He's standing at about the 30-yard line. And it's a nice high kick, but it's into the wind, and it will take a Fort Stockton bounce.
Wow.
And so the ball is blown dead at the 49-yard line. Man, that ball rolled way back 12 more yards? It took a 12-yard bounce for Fort Stockton.
A 12-yard punt,
okay. Well, it sure took a big roll back for Fort Stockton, too, of about that same amount, I would think.
Well, I call a 12-yard punt a dozen.
Yeah, yeah.
And, yeah, we got great field position. Let's see if we can go – well, let's go 4 for 4 here in the second half.
Yeah, have we gone 3 for 3?
Did we? I think so.
Darrell says yes. Okay. 1st down and 10 for the Panthers, ball at our own 49-yard line. The best scoring second half we've had this season, so that's good to see. Single running back. We put a receiver in motion. Marco Garcia pitches it out to Pedro Gonzalez. And Pedro coming around the left side stays in bounds. A lot of guts on that play by Pedro to stay in bounds, to try to get extra yardage. And it's a net gain of 3 yards, and it's 2nd and 7 coming up for the Panthers.
I like the play. Let's move them around. Make them run side to side. So.
Yeah. Pedro came from, you know, right to left on that play and got the pitch. All right, it's 2nd and 7. Marco in the shotgun again. He'll hand it off up the middle, and a nice-looking running play again for nice yardage. About 4 on the play is gained by our running back, Isaiah Velasquez, and it will bring up 3rd and 3. The ball at the Crane 44-yard line with 9:34 in the fourth quarter now. This is going to be a much quicker ball game than the past ones have been.
Well, we've had so many penalties and turnovers, it just takes a lot of time. We're missing a player. Somebody needs to run out there. We got plenty of time.
All right, it's third and three. We send out Isaiah Velasquez at receiver at the last moment. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. Very high snap, and it's a fumble, but it's picked immediately up. Oh, and there's a face mask, and here's Jadrian still going inside the 20 down to the 17-yard line.
Wow.
That's a 26-yard carry, I believe, by Jadrian, and he was face masked on the way down, and that should add half the distance to the goal.
Well, unless one of these flags, there's three flags, and they may have all called it because they about yanked his helmet all the way around, and great job to keep his feet, pick up some extra yardage.
That'll be half the distance to the goal.
And you know what? He fielded that. That was a high snap, and I think the ball bounced up, and he's able to field it and then take off for a great run.
Well, that's an M&J Trucking Company outstanding play on the fumble, on, you know, as a result of the high snap. But Jadrian, what a heads-up play to just pick the fumble up on the bounce and then gain a big play. All right, it's first and goal, brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company at about the 9-yard line for the Panthers. Shotgun for Marco Garcia. Two receivers on the left, one on the right. And the running back is Isaiah Velasquez. Here's Marco taking a high snap again. Isaiah around the right side. He was bumped a time or two, but he's in the end zone for a touchdown of 9 yards for the Panthers. That is a Triple R Welding touchdown.
Well, that really, I tell you, our line is opening up some big holes. Isaiah did a nice job. I think that play was designed to go inside. He bounced it outside to daylight and scores.
All of the running backs are looking really, really good. And the quarterback tonight's done a great job as well.
And they're hanging on to the ball.
Yes. Aiden Villarreal puts the kick up. Let's see if we make this one. Yes. 46-6. That's make that a Triple R Welding PAT. And our M&J Fast Loop score update, 46-6, Fort Stockton over Crane. We'll be back in a moment.
The schools of Fort Stockton ISD provide comprehensive educational services in our community. Hello. This is Dr. Gabe Zamora, superintendent. Whatever the educational need, we are committed to doing our best. This includes providing a safe environment and opportunities to improve the education of your student. We are extremely proud of our students and their accomplishments. We are proud to sponsor FSISD sports broadcasts for those unable to attend. Go Panthers and go Prowlers!
When you need supplies in the oil field, the choice is clear. Choose Triple G Supply and Services in Fort Stockton. They have all the oil field supplies you need, including general oil field supplies, PVC pipe and fittings, hydraulic hoses, generators, safety equipment, household supplies, and much more. They also have roustabout services available. Triple G Supply and Services is right here in Fort Stockton at the west end of Dickinson at 1048 Crockett Avenue. Delivery is available to your location. Call 336-8284 Triple G Supply and Services.
All right, we're back. We've got a kickoff about to happen for Fort Stockton, but the wind blew the ball off the tee. And the wind is coming out of the south-southeast tonight at
that's just a rumor.
10 to 20 miles per hour. Pretty stiff wind, actually.
It is, yeah. And we've got the wind.
We do, for the rest of the game.
And we're going to win.
I don't think Crane's going to come back from 40 points down, no.
No. They weren't going to come down. They weren't going to win when they were up 6-0.
Okay, so here we go. I think we have to now hold the ball after the second blow-off, don't we? So that's what's going to happen here.
That's Russian rules. I don't know what you're
talking about. All right, here's Aiden Villarreal kicking it, and it's muffed by Crane at the 11-yard line, but they pick it up, and it's going to be great coverage by the Panthers. The return man was Blake Rodriguez for Crane. And he has stopped at about the 22-yard line. So that's good kick coverage by Fort Stockton.
Well, Crane is really on their heels. We have, since the first quarter, you know, we woke up in the second quarter, but that third quarter and now to start the fourth, Fort Stockton's really on a roll.
Well, this is going to be our biggest win of the year, point-wise.
And we've got a lot of backups in right now. That's the great thing when you get a big lead in the fourth quarter is everybody gets to play.
That's right. So here we go with the first and 10 at the 22-yard line, I formation. Hand off to the fullback. And that's going to be a nice gain for the fullback of about 11, maybe 12 yards. About 12 yards up to the 34-yard line, first and 10 for Crane. Boy, they've not had much offense in the second half, but that's one of their best play probably of the second half.
They're doing pretty good against a number of extra players.
M&J Fast Lube score update is Fort Stockton 46, Crane 6. And it's nice to see the Panthers really have a complete game tonight. You know, the first quarter, yes, we struggled. We had penalties, mistakes. But from the second quarter on, the Panthers have played very well.
Yes, they have. And I tell you,
there's about a five-yard gain by Crane. Number three, I think, the ball carrier, Blake Rodriguez. Five-yard gain, second and five.
And it is homecoming.
Yes.
Cruz Rojas is our homecoming king. Jacinda Gonzalez, the queen. So congrats to them.
You were in the parade last night with your Corvair, weren't you?
Yes, I was. I drove the Corvair. It made it all the way from start to finish.
Okay. Engine in the rear, isn't that right?
It is.
Second and five. Here's the pitch out play to the tailback. And this will be Galvan, or Galindo, I should say. I believe he's got about a six-yard gain. First down for Crane to the 45-yard line.
See, one of Darrell's grandkids has run up to the window.
All right, it's a first and 10 for Crane at the 45. Yeah, that was one of Darrell's many grandchildren.
Yes.
How many have you got, Darrell?
17.
14? With one on the way.
Ah.
Wow. A prolific bunch, those Scots.
I didn't know he was Scottish.
First down and 10, ball at the 45. Offset I formation. Here's the pitch out. And, again, that goes to Galindo. He's going to have about a two-yard gain this time. The Panthers strung that one out pretty well. And a lot of backups in there right now playing. And so they're getting some nice playing time. Second down and 8 after a two-yard gain for Crane.
It really is. I mean, that's good. I said we'd win by 30, but, you know, we're up by 40, and I don't care if we win by 30 now. Fort Stockton was a 16-point favorite. We played well after the first quarter, and it shows.
Darren, we're 3-0, about to be 4-0. Here's the second and 8 play, and the running back and quarterback kind of ran into each other that time, and it will be about a 1-yard gain, 3rd and 6. But we've got El Paso Isleta on the road next week, Darren, with a chance to go to 5-0 going into district play with an open week there. And that would be pretty neat if we could do that.
We need to do that. You know what I thought when they ran into each other? You know what I thought that looked like?
What?
A little pirouette.
No.
In the backfield. We had a little pirouette in the backfield, and it didn't work.
No, a pirouette is graceful. That's what Jadrian did.
Not that, no.
3rd and 6, and that was almost a hold on Crane, but, man, great pursuit on the quarterback.
Wow.
And he is sacked. Number 32 got the sack for Fort Stockton, Evian Acosta. And that'll bring him back to the 45-yard line, a loss of 5 on the play, or a loss of about 4 maybe, and it's 4th down and 10 for Crane, and here comes the punt team with 5:12 to go in the game.
I think they just brought Evian up from the JV. That's Ethan's younger brother. I would say smaller, but he's actually bigger than Ethan. So
Isaiah Garcia is back to return this punt. The line of scrimmage, the 45 of Crane. All right, here's the wobbly kick. It's a short one. Takes a Fort Stockton bounce again up to about the 37-yard line. Okay, we've got 4:44 left in this ball game. And don't forget, we've got the West Texas High School Scoreboard Show coming up after Panther football from 10 to 12 tonight. In fact, it'll start right after Panther football. They've kind of got a pre-scoreboard, right?
They do.
Starting at 9:30.
Oh, we have Dr.
Superintendent Dr. Zamora just came up to the booth.
He's pretty happy on homecoming.
I bet he is, yeah.
So, well, you know, really, again, a slow start by the Panthers, but what a way to finish, I tell you. This third quarter and the whole second half, Fort Stockton has just really been impressive.
All right, the line of scrimmage, the 38-yard line for the Panthers. Let's see, who's playing quarterback right now? It is number 21, Zane Natividad, and Natividad will gain not T.B. Dodd, but it's the running back gaining three. Who did he hand it off to that time?
I'm not sure.
Is it number 40? Dylan Alvarado?
42.
Giovanni Hernandez.
Good job. Darren's younger brother.
Zane Natividad at quarterback. And it looked like there was a flag on the play. That might have been an offsides on Crane. Now, if the Crane player jumped into the line, it might have caused our player to go in motion. Maybe the center. No, it's an offsides against Crane.
Offsides against Crane.
We'll take it.
I think their beak was lined up offside.
You think?
That's what I saw.
Daryl and I used to talk about Crane a lot when they had the propane crane.
Yes.
That even rhymes. Second and two. All right, that's a nice run by Fort Stockton for a first down to the 46-yard line of Crane. That'll be an 8-yard pickup for a Rainwater Motor Company first down.
I think that was Giovanni again, wasn't it?
I think so. Giovanni Hernandez, maybe, on the carry. Yes.
All of our running backs have done a very good job here in this second half.
And, you know, the JV and freshman teams are also undefeated.
Wow.
This year. How long has it been since that's happened?
I believe
since all three teams at this point in the year are undefeated.
I believe Teddy Roosevelt was president the last time that happened.
First and 10, and here's the handoff, and that's going to be for a loss on the play. Giovanni is caught for a loss by Tavian Bustos for Crane. That's a nice defensive play there, and it's a loss of two, brings up second and 12.
Giovanni said, you know, when we're running the zone read and the guy's already tackling me, go ahead and pull it out and take off on your own. Don't hand it to me.
Yeah. Well, this will be by far the shortest game as far as amount of time is concerned tonight, and we're already. And here's a fake handoff. Zane Natividad executes that beautifully. His helmet comes off as he goes to the ground.
I think he was face mask. I think there's a flag. I think they yanked his face mask and yanked his helmet off.
That's a 15-yard pickup plus that lost yardage for Zane Natividad, and that'll be a Rainwater Motor Company first down. And that's, we're going to call that an M&J Trucking Company outstanding play. And a face mask will be added on to the end of this. Wow.
I think, you know, Crane's had quite a few face mask calls here in the second half. I think they're tired and they're just reaching on these tackles.
Okay, here we go with the Panthers down inside the red zone at about the 18-yard line. Zane Natividad in the shotgun. He will hand this ball off for a short gain this time. A couple of Crane defenders are there to meet the running back, Giovanni Hernandez, in the hole for no gain really on the play. It'll bring up second and 10. And now there's 2.5 minutes left in the ball game.
2.5 minutes.
Yeah.
It's time for the 2.5 minute warning. Oh, wait, we don't have that, do we?
I think Seminole was leading Andrews now. Is that right?
Really big, like 35-16.
Second and 10. Here's the handoff. No, it's a keeper by Zane Natividad, and he is slung to the ground after a first down of 12 yards. And Trey Larson was the guy that just really slung him down right there. But yeah, it's a first and goal for the Panthers at the 8-yard line.
We should probably take a knee, but I'd almost say after that kind of tackle, just go ahead and score on him. I don't like that.
Well, that was a bit of a rough tackle.
Well, I mean, it's unnecessary. That's one of those deals that sometimes a penalty.
Yeah, sometimes it is. So we've got Zane Natividad at quarterback and Giovanni Hernandez at running back. A lot of backups in. And here's the handoff right up the middle to Giovanni. He is stopped for a short gain, about 2 yards, down to the 6-yard line. And it'll be second and goal or third and goal?
Yeah, if they don't call timeout, I just take a knee, I think, and run out the clock.
It's third and goal. Third and goal at the 7.
Oh, okay. I'd still take a knee and run the clock down. I think we can.
Well, we've got 19 seconds left on the play clock. This backup unit, they probably want to score.
Well, a lot of ways I would. I've lost some games to Crane. I wouldn't mind scoring one more time.
Okay, it's Zane Natividad at quarterback, 50 seconds. And we will take a knee at the 10-yard line. So that's proper thing to do from a sportsmanlike standpoint, Darren.
And I think they're going to wait until they almost started the clock late. So, you know, we can snap the ball and the game will be over. Just snap the ball, dance around for 2 seconds, and that'll be it.
Yeah, there's
don't snap it early.
About a 3 or 4 second difference between the game clock and the play clock. And it's fourth down and goal back at the 10-yard line as we took a knee on the last play.
Yep.
And we're about to wind this one up. Zane Natividad at quarterback. There's 9 seconds and counting on the play clock. And this homecoming crowd's going to be happy.
I'm happy.
Yeah. And Zane takes another knee. And
oh, he took it too fast.
Yeah, he really did. They're probably going to put 2 or 3 seconds on the clock, but are they just going to say the game is over?
I am. It's over. It's over at halftime.
All right, folks. That is the end of the ball game. Our final score. It's a M&J Fast Lube game score update. Final, Fort Stockton 46, Crane 6. And we'll be back with Panther football in a moment.
If you're building and using concrete, it's because you want the finished project to last a long, long time. So why take chances with just any concrete provider? You want a company that delivers what you want, where you want it, and at a fair price. That's why the number one concrete provider in our area is Big Bend Concrete. From driveways to highways, slabs to culverts, Big Bend Concrete does it all. So give them a call at 837-7179. Big Bend Concrete. Solid.
Doctors Josh Pass, Brian Cherry, and Hewlin Pass are optometrists serving the West Texas area. Visit West Texas Eye Care at 605 North Main in Fort Stockton or 611 South Oak in Pecos. They offer complete and thorough eye examinations for the whole family, including therapeutic optometry, eyeglasses, contact lenses, laser surgery consultation, and screenings for macular degeneration and diabetes with an in-office lab. Call to make an appointment today in Fort Stockton at 336-3662 or in Pecos 445-3662.
Friday, September 16th through Thursday, September 22nd, Panther Pictures will be showing Paws of Fury at the theater located at the Convention Center. A down-on-his-luck hound finds himself in a town full of cats who need a hero to defend them from a ruthless villain's evil plot. With help from a reluctant trainer, the underdog must assume the role of fearsome samurai and save the day. Everyone's invited to this animated film at Panther Pictures in Fort Stockton.
Buck's Lube Center is located at 310 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. They feature quick oil changes, multi-point vehicle checks, inspection stickers, and fuel filters for all vehicles, specializing in mobile oil but with Motorcraft also in stock. Buck's Lube Center is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 5 p.m. Remember, for reasonable prices and great service, it's Buck's Lube Center, 310 West Dickinson, Fort Stockton. They hope to serve you on every oil change.
Do you know where to get a great lunch special for a very affordable price? At Bienvenidos Mexican Restaurant, of course. Their lunch special is only $8 and is served Monday through Friday at lunchtime. Monday, it's a fajita chicken salad. Tuesday, the taco plate. Wednesday, the vaquero sandwich. Thursday, Bienvenidos Nachos. And Friday, the enchilada plate is on special. And don't forget to come by Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. for a delicious Mexican-style breakfast. That's Bienvenidos, open Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. at 405 East Dickinson.
This is Dakota Livesay for the Pecos County State Bank. The ethic of West Texas is one of dedication. Hard work, chin up, get it done. Long hours and extra effort always pays off in the long run. At the Pecos County State Bank, you will find employees who will do what it takes to make sure you are satisfied. You will find dedication, a West Texas institution since 1928. The Pecos County State Bank, all the bank you'll ever need. Member FDIC.
All right, we are back at the conclusion of tonight's game. A great performance by our Fort Stockton Panthers tonight in a very complete game. The first quarter was the only quarter where we really had some issues, but we corrected all that and got really rolling in the second period for 3 touchdowns and then just kept it on going in the second half. So, Darryl Scott, you've got some stats for us. You've been keeping it, keeping these on your new app, and that's pretty fancy. So tell us about these stats, Darryl.
Yeah, we hope they're right. Fort Stockton, total offense, 388 yards. good offensive showing for Fort Stockton. Quite a bit of passing involved in that. We did have 59 yards passing, and that we were 9 of 13, so pretty good success there. That opens up the running game as well as really I think we wore them down in the second half. Crane's total offense, 56 yards. Now, if you'll remember, at halftime they had 45 yards. So
that's incredible.
Just a stifling defense. Fort Stockton right at our average, giving up 6 points a game if you look at the average. So typical defense performance for Fort Stockton, and it's a good one. Again, 59 receiving yards for Fort Stockton, 9 for Crane. They had some losses in their reception. Didn't throw the ball that many times. One of them was for a touchdown. Fort Stockton also threw for a touchdown. Kind of a flip tonight. We have Crane with 8 penalties for 79 yards, and those came at bad times for them. 5 for 50 yards for Fort Stockton. And that's better than it's been. It's still probably not as good as we'd like. Turned around the turnover deal. We only had one turnover tonight. Go Fort Stockton. Crane had 2 turnovers. They had several fumbles that they didn't lose. Again, a good showing by the defense. Looking at the first downs, Fort Stockton with 30 first downs.
Wow.
We just were just ramming it down their throat. And Crane with only 5. Most of our first downs came by the way of rush. Just a few individual stats. Marco Garcia, 8 of 12 for 60 yards with 1 TD. Zane Natividad had one attempt, and it was for minus 1 yard, and I think that's one they sniffed out. On the rushing, this is pretty impressive. Looking at the top 3 rushers, Corbin Luna, 24 attempts, 148 yards, 6.2 yards per average, two TDs.
That's his best game far this year.
Yeah, that's a good game. Jadian Ramirez, 7 carries for 76 yards. Really a good average, 10.9. He had a TD. Isaiah Velasquez, 9 for 57 yards with 2 TDs. He averaged 6.3.
Yeah.
So looking really good for Fort Stockton offensively and defensively. And here's the scoring plays. Crane started it all off. 10 minutes, 12 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Keaton Sienna passed to number 4, Trey Larson, for a 13-yard touchdown pass. We think he may have been bobbling it, but we don't know for sure. But that was it. That was all the scoring they were going to get in the second quarter. Fort Stockton with 8:23 left. Corbin Luna runs a 4-yard rushing touchdown, and the point after was good. Second quarter, 2:45 left. Corbin Luna, a 2-yard rush for a touchdown. Point after was good. That we were 14-6 at that point. With 55 seconds left in the first half, we had a pass from Marco Garcia to Isaiah Garcia, 19-yard touchdown pass, 21-6. And so to that point, our kicker was good on everything. In the third quarter, Fort Stockton, 8:05 left, Jadian Ramirez runs for 2 yards, and point after was blocked, 27-6. Third quarter, 5:07 remaining. Number 13, Isaiah Velasquez, runs for 7 yards, and that's 33-6. The block kick was blocked. Third quarter again with 37 seconds. Marco Garcia runs a 1-yard quarterback keeper for a touchdown, 39-6. Point after blocked. And in the fourth quarter, only one score for Fort Stockton, 8:54 left. Isaiah Velasquez, 9-yard run, and point after was good. And Fort Stockton kneeled on the ball at the end of the game, probably could have gone in and scored. A great game, Ken.
Well, the Panthers had some penalty problems in the first half, but really shut that down in the second half, and then also improved in the turnover margin greatly tonight, from 8 turnovers last week to only 1 this week. So it's really fabulous improvement by this Panther football team in this ball game.
Yeah, I thought it was. I thought, you know, we did some things, and, you know, I like our adjustments. I think in the first quarter, Crane probably did some things that fooled us. But after that first quarter, we came back, and we were down 6-0, and then we scored 46 straight points.
All right, Darren, we're going to be back in a moment. You've got some scores for us, and we'll be back after these words.
Stuck in a state of falling behind? Struggling to keep up with your kids, finances, insurance? Then let State Farm Automobile Insurance Company help you simplify and get to a better state. Because I, Kessie Ledesma, your local State Farm agent, can handle your auto, home, and life insurance, so you'll have more time for everything else. Call me today at 432-336-8575 and get to a better state with State Farm.
D&L Well Service is now mowing lots. They have everything you need to get that land neat and clean. Our tractors and shredders can make quick work of a job that may be too big for you. Do you want to sell your land? Let's make it look its best. D&L has the right equipment for every size. D&L Well Service's roustabout crews are the best in the business. They're local, experienced, and professional. They can do EPA cleanups, painting and sandblasting, backhoe work, and SWD maintenance. D&L Well Service is here to help you. Call anytime, day or night, 432-336-8101.
Hey, Panther fans, this is Rudy Franco with Amistad Motors, inviting you to come out and take a look at our pre-owned inventory. We have a good selection of cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have several certified pre-owned units that come with an extended warranty. So if you are in the market for a new or pre-owned vehicle, drive on over to 2110 West Dickinson or give us a call at 336-9000. Amistad Motors, friends serving friends. Go Blue!
Sawyer Insurance Agency has six locations in West Texas to serve you, including 706 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton and 1502 South Stockton Avenue in Monahans, along with offices in Pecos, Midland, Lubbock, and Amarillo. They offer the most complete line of commercial and personal insurance from workers' comp, general liability, business and personal auto, commercial property, equipment, oil and gas, farm and ranch, and home insurance. Contact Clyde, Nathan, or Travis Sawyer today by calling 336-7543 or 943-9600. The Steakhouse Restaurant has been serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area for many years with consistently great food and fast, friendly service. They offer daily lunch specials on weekdays at a great value. Each special comes with appropriate sides, super salad, and drink. And they were voted to have the best steaks and enchiladas in Fort Stockton. The Steakhouse Restaurant, open Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. till 9 p.m. at 1100 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. The First National Bank of Fort Stockton is proud to be the first local bank to offer a new mobile check deposit app. Yes, the First National Bank, always at the cutting edge of technology, is now offering a mobile app with which you can take a picture of a check and it will be immediately accepted as a deposit to your account. It's just another great innovation through the latest technology from the friendly First National Bank of Fort Stockton. Stop by for all the details at the First National Bank, 1000 West Dickinson, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender. Hernandez Sanitation in Fort Stockton proudly serves a large portion of West Texas with sanitation services, including the oil field, for portable toilets, holding tanks, septic tank service, grease trap service, or large roll-off trash containers. Contact Hernandez Sanitation today by calling owner and operator Joe Angel Hernandez at 432-336-3803. Hernandez Sanitation, a proud member of the Fort Stockton community, always supporting all the athletic and extracurricular activities in Fort Stockton schools. America can depend on Farmers Insurance agent Adelina Salazar to provide you with low-cost insurance coverage in all areas of your life. Farmers can provide auto, home, life, health insurance, and much more. Farmers Insurance agent Adelina Salazar also writes commercial property insurance policies for liability, fire and casualty, and more. Contact your West Texas Farmers Insurance agent Adelina Salazar today next to the post office at 104 East 4th. Call 336-5311.
Okay, we are back, and Darren Hodges is the score guru tonight. So go ahead, Darren, give us some scores.
I want to start off with some 4A division scores. Pecos Eagles upset Stanton 14-0. Clint Lyons are losing to El Paso Bel Air at halftime 14-7. Fort Stockton, of course, over Crane 46-6. That is a final. Monahans beat Snyder 48-21, final score. We've got Paladuro losing to Canyon West Plains Wolves 28-26. Estacado over Leveland 39-13. In an interesting game, Andrews was up 15-14 and ends up losing that game 36-15. So a big win tonight for Seminole. We've got Canadian over Perryton, 49-7. Bushland over Borger, 51-13. And a final score, a little bit interesting. Big Spring knocks off Sweetwater, 20-7. Midland Greenwood is leading Shallowwater, 43-21 in an upset. We've got Wichita Falls beating Carrollton. I don't care about that score. Graham over Iowa Park, 24-17. I don't care much about that one either. Let's go up to 6A, see if we can see some scores. We've got, looks like Odessa Permian is leading Harker Heights, 28-27, with just 16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. San Angelo Central upsets Belton, 35-12. Anye Bobcats, Wolforth over Abilene, 21-7. The Bulldogs of Midland, I had a score, but now it has disappeared. So I don't know if my wife's Bulldogs won or not, but they were winning that game. Amarillo Sandys over the Odessa Broncos, 42-17. Cibolo over Midland Legacy in the fourth quarter, 28-21 in a close game. Let's go to 5A Division One. Looks like we've got, what's the score I care about? Esleta, we play them next week. They're losing to Burgess 17-0 at halftime. Andrus is leading Horizon 16-2 at halftime. Two teams we've played. Canyon Eagles knock off Amarillo Caprock 35-32. Looks like Abilene Cooper 33, Lubbock Coronado 28. I announce that as a final.
Okay.
Yes, Wichita Falls Rider falls to Lubbock Cooper in a close game, 24-21. That was probably a very good game. We've got Tascosa over Hereford, 56-10. Leaves the white faces red-faced. That's too bad. Amarillo Sandys over the Odessa Broncos, 42-17. Let's go down to 5A Division II, see if we can pick up any other scores that might be of interest. We know Lakeview beat the Lubbock Westerners, 35-21. Cooper Cougars over Coronado of Lubbock, 33-28. Plainview loses to Dumas, 57-6. We've got Stephenville leading Abilene Wiley 49-42 with about 6 minutes left in that game. As we drop down into, let's look down to 3A Division One. See if we can. Kermit Yellow Jackets beat Midland TLC 62-0. Everyone knows they're at least 1-3. Denver City is leading Lovington 14-0. That is at halftime. Lubbock Roosevelt over Slayton 33-22. Littlefield over La Mesa 42-0. Brownfield beats Dimmitt 61-10. That's not a bad word. It is a town. And we've got, again, we've got a final here. Midland Greenwood 43, Shallowwater 28. Bit of an upset. If you wanted to know about Mule Shoe over Tulia, I'm not telling you. Bushland leading Borger 51-13. Dalhart loses to Friona 49-26. We drop down to 3A to 2A. Any scores of interest as I scroll through? Floyd Data losing to New Home Leopards, 28-14. Bovina, I don't care about them either. Let's see if we can find some six-man scores that might be of interest. Valley, I don't care about them either. I'm not seeing any scores I really care about. Rankin Red Devils are losing to the Knox City Greyhounds, 43-42. But there's 4 minutes left, time for plenty more scoring in that game. And I've got Balmoray over Marfa, 60-0. What a shock. Fort Davis beats Fort Hancock, 2-0. I think that was a forfeit. Garden City losing to May, 57-34. I'm just not seeing a lot of these. Borden County, Roy Tan, Sanderson, Van Horn, 0-0. That can't be right. I'll look at one more division, see if there's any scores of interest in Division 2A. Clarendon, Crosbyton, Sudan. Sudan beats Seagraves 36-20. I think I picked that one. That's about it. Scores okay. of interest.
All right. Well, thanks, Darren. We will be back, and we'll wrap up. In fact, we'll wrap up the broadcast right here. Our final score tonight, Fort Stockton beats Crane, 46-6, the final. They've still got the scoreboard on. We're proud of that.
I love it. I say we show it all week when we win.
Okay, 46-6, Fort Stockton wins. And that's going to wrap it up from Panther Stadium. Stay tuned. The West Texas High School Scoreboard Show is coming up next.
B3 Properties, managers of the Apache, Green Tree, Chaparral, and Sunset Apartments, and managers of A1 Mini Storage, are having a move-in special. That's right, right now, check out the move-in special going on their apartments and storage buildings. Don't miss out on these great move-in specials. Stop by B3 Properties at 808 West Dickinson or call for more information at 336-5003.
The Oasis